Good afternoon, everybody, from Foxborough Stadium. Here in Foxborough, Massachusetts, Kurt Gowdy, Hank Stram. We've just had the opening kickoff. The Vikings ran it back to their own 45, and we're set to go. The Vikings in white won the toss. Come up to the line of scrimmage with Tommy Kramer, the quarterback. He's played every down in every game this year. The handoff goes to Ted Brown. Brown, the running back, is stopped by Steve Nelson, the linebacker, at the Viking 46-yard line. It'll be second down, 9 to go. Let's set you up now with the Viking offense. Tommy Kramer is the quarterback. Ricky Young, 34. Ted Brown, 23, the running back. Ahmad Rashad, Sammy White are the wide receivers, and Bob Tucker is the tight end. Riley, up, Willie, Hamilton, Yeri are the interior linemen. In motion, Ricky Young. Kramer for the throw. Sideline, skipping out is Rashad. He is the leading wide receiver pass catcher in the league. Joe Washington, the running back, has caught the most passes. Ray Claiborne drove him out. They're short of the first down.
You know, the great thing about Tommy Kramer.
Let's take a look at the defense first, Hank. Lunsford, Hamilton, and Bishop are the three down linemen. Hawkins, Nelson, Hunt, and Choate are the linebackers. We have Claiborne and Haynes in the corners, and Samford and Fox, the safety men. Third down, 4. The ball on the 50-yard line. Vikings in possession. Voigt's gone in as the tight end. Kramer will try to throw for this first down. Flares it out. Drop, incomplete pass. Nelson was there to make the hit on Ricky Young, and it's 4th and 4.
Boy, Steve Nelson really did a good job of anticipating the play. He waited, went back to his hook area, and then when the ball was finally thrown, got a good jump on the ball and came up and made a very fine play on that lateral pass. Wasn't really a lateral pass, it was a forward pass, but it was behind the line of scrimmage.
Greg Coleman in punt formation. He punted 10 times last week to tie an all-time Viking single game record. Stanley Morgan, one of the better punt returners in the league, averaging 10 yards a return. The kick's away. Morgan is going to field it on the 15. He was courageous on that one. And his forward motion will stop on his own 17-yard line where the Patriots put the ball in play. And Darrell Luce, a reserve linebacker, went down to cover the punt for the Minnesota Vikings.
You know, this New England team, Curtis, has very unusual stats for a team that's not in the playoffs. They're 4th in total offense, 5th rushing, 7th passing. And the Vikings, on the other side of the ball, are 9th in total defense, 13 against the rush, and 6 against the pass.
Steve Grogan will quarterback this club. He'll be number 14. We'll give you their lineup here after the first play. Slight breeze of the Patriots back. Out to Stan Morgan. Morgan's up to the 30 and is downed on his 32-yard line for a first down. Jeff Seaman dragged him down. Stanley Morgan will be in the Pro Bowl. That's his 42nd reception of this year. There's the backfield. Grogan, Ivory, Calhoun. Cunningham is out with an injury. Morgan and Jackson to the wide men. And Hasselbeck is the tight end. Russ Francis is injured. Brock, Hanna, Lenkaitis, Kreider, and Jordan are the interior linemen. Patriots ball, first down under 32. Ivory hit behind the line, shaking away, and is thrown for a loss. He'll be dropped on his own 29-yard line. In there making penetration, coming up is a strong safety, Tom Hannon. And Jim White, the right tackle. Second down, 13. New England Patriots on their own 29. First time the Vikings have ever played at Schaefer Stadium. Back in 1970, they played at Harvard Stadium when the Patriots were moving around from stadium to stadium. Grogan for his second throw. Nearly picked off there by Bobby Bryant, number 20. Not quite. Intended for Harold Jackson.
Jackson didn't take him deep enough that time. Bryant played the ball well, but he didn't get him out of his back pedal hardly at all before he made his outside move. For that reason, he had a good chance to make a play on the ball when it was thrown to the outside to Harold Jackson.
Three wide receivers. Minnesota uses a four-man front. Mullaney, Roller, White, and Marshall up there. Blair, Seaman, McNeil, the linebackers. They have a nickel defense in there now. Third down, 13 for New England from their own 29-yard line. They're blitzing him. He's under the gun. He throws it out to the 35 and falling forward is Horace Ivory to the 36-yard line. And a kicking situation coming up for New England.
They try to throw underneath. The linebackers get pretty good depth. And they have five defensive backs. He gets away from trouble, throws the ball inside, but not nearly enough room for the first down. And they're in a kicking situation now after they throw the ball to Horace Ivory for a short gain.
Heath Beller is the safety man. Here's the punt by Eddie Hare. A good kick against the wind. And with the wind to the 15, to the 20. Flag is down to the 25, and out of bounds on the 27 goes Keith Miller. And he's taken out there by number 53, Bill Matthews, a linebacker. Let's see what this flag's about. That's a legal use of the hands against the Vikings. Now it's strange, Hank, to finish the year knowing that the Vikings are not going to be in the playoffs. First time they missed the playoffs since 1972.
You know, really, and even though they haven't made the playoffs, they've done a good job. I think probably, Bud, let's listen to the call here.
Holding number 47 on the run back. First down.
I think the Vikings going into the season, very few people anticipated any degree of success, and I think they've overachieved with a 7-8 record at this stage of the season for the kind of a season they expected at the beginning of the year.
Kevin Miller's 15-yard punt return wiped out. In motion is the rookie Ted Brown. Kramer to put it up. His toss is nearly intercepted by Rod Schultz. Right in his arms, and he couldn't hold on to it.
It was a bootleg pass. They faked a run to the right, and then he rolls to his left, and Schultz is really the only one that's really open on the play. It was right to him. You could tell he was a little unsure as he threw the ball. You watch his feet, a little nervousness in the feet. Anytime you see a quarterback do that, you know he's a little bit unsure. He wasn't sure, threw the ball right into traffic, and it really should have been intercepted.
Second down, 10. Mike Hawkins is out. Ray Kostick comes in as a linebacker. Vikings operating from their own 17. Ricky Young, slide hole, plows over his 21, dropped at his 21 there by Mel Lunsford, the left end, and Steve Nelson, a truly outstanding middle linebacker who does not get the credit around the country he deserves.
Yeah, it's amazing that he didn't make the Pro Bowl team because he's really a good one. And on defense, unusual for a team to be number one in total defense and not make the playoffs. They're number one in total defense, four against the rush, and number one against the pass.
All right, Rashad is set to the right. They're in a slot left. Terry LeCount comes in to give the Vikings three wide receivers. Kramer looking, short one, dropped, incomplete, and Minnesota will have to punt again. Ray Kostick jarred the ball loose, intended for Ricky Young. Greg Coleman, who's averaged just under 40 yards a kick, will boot against a 10-mile-an-hour wind to Stanley Morgan, who is a blazer. Morgan's on his own 40. Getting overcast now. It's been really a beautiful December morning here in New England. Sunny, warm. It kicks away. Wobbly spiral. Fair catch by Morgan. Fields it on his 45-yard line. Patriots ball, first down. Well, we're early in the first period. 10 minutes, 51 seconds remaining in this quarter, and no score. Jim Marshall received a tremendous ovation here in Foxborough when he came out in the field. He's winding it up, a storybook 20-year career. Only George Blanda and Earl Morrill have played more seasons than Jim Marshall. Number 70, the defensive right end of the Vikings. Don Calhoun, ripping over the 50, is into Viking territory. And he'll be stopped at the Viking 49-yard line by Dave Roller, who cut him under. Telecast presented by Authority of the National Football League. It's intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the Patriots and the National Football League is prohibited. Marshall also holds several records we'll tell you about.
If they run this time, they ought to run to the left with the way the defense is set up. That's providing they do run. No, they're running right.
That's Ivory. Ivory squirming a yard or two. Kurt Knopf, number 25, the free safety, racked him up. And they'll spot him on the 48 of the Vikings.
That time the defense was overloaded to the offensive right. They had a soft spot to the left. I don't know why he didn't change the play, but he ran right into the traffic and didn't do much on the play.
Patriots send in Westbrook to join Morgan and Jackson, get the tight end out. They have three wide receivers. Jim Marshall holds the record for recovering opponents' fumbles, 29 of them. One of them he recovered and ran the wrong way, became a national name, follow Roy Regal. They're going to try and run it. Ivory just gets back to the line of scrimmage, and that's all. Dave Roller again made the primary hit on him. And Eddie Hare comes in. Some of the fans booing the Patriots here. They have been under intense pressure the last two or three weeks, especially after they lost to the Jets. Been a disappointing season for a team that many picked to easily win their division, maybe even wind up in the Super Bowl. Kevin Miller's a safety man. Eddie Hare to do the kicking, averaging 36 yards a kick. A driving spiral, and this one is into the end zone for the touchback. Vikings ball, first down on their own 20. There's always reason for disappointment. Now, before the Vikings put the ball in play here in the first period, 9 to go in this quarter, no score. Vikings ball on their own 20. They've been pinned back in their own territory, deep, have not had any kind of field position so far. Ricky Young and Ted Brown are the running backs, set behind young Tommy Kramer, completing his third year in the National Football League from Rice University. Ricky Young. Young for a yard, maybe two. Steve Nelson again. He leads the Patriots in tackles this year with 122 solo tackles.
One thing that's very difficult to do against this New England team is to run sideways, to have your halfback line up on the right side of the ball and try to run it all the way over to the left side, because by the time you get there, New England is there waiting for you, especially the linebackers. It's an awful long time for the offensive line to hold their blocks against this quick reacting team, the New England Patriots.
That's Sammy White, 85. Set out on the other side is Ahmad Rashad.
There's a passing formation.
Second down, 9. Big rush on. Gets it out to Ricky Young, and Young's out of bounds on the 26-yard line of the Vikings. Watch the rush here on Kramer.
He has a lot of poise. We've seen him one other occasion during the course of this season, twice really, but he looks like he's going to be a real good player, an excellent player. Good rush on the inside from Richard Bishop, but he got the ball off in good shape. Rashad, coming into this game, came in with 72 catches.
Bishop has 8.5 sacks. That's second to Tony McGee, who just gone in, who leads the team. Tony the Sack McGee, they call him, 11.5 sacks.
Another passing formation.
Third down and 4, slot right. Kramer coming out, has a first down, 35, still going, and dives almost to his 40-yard line. That's the first down for the Vikings.
And, you know, that's one of the nice things about this young quarterback, Tommy Kramer. He has the capacity to run with the football and has a good feel for pressure. He goes back into the pocket, sees some room in the middle area, takes advantage of it, very decisive, makes a good move on Steve Nelson, forces him to miss the tackle. Ran that time like a halfback, but he made a nice gain on the play. His first and 10, Minnesota.
Vikings ball on their 40. No score, 7.5 to go in the first period. Draw play, Ricky Young to the 40. A yard, and that's it. Steve Nelson again on the tackle, number 57 from North Dakota State in his sixth year with New England. It'll be second down, 9 for the Vikings on their own 41. Tonight on CBS, 60 Minutes. Archie Bunker's play, One Day at a Time, and the 4th annual Circus of the Stars, all on CBS tonight. White set to the right, Rashad left. We have some great wide receivers Both teams in this game.
Another passing formation, obvious. Play action.
Kramer whips it out, and it's out of bounds. His receiver fell down, Sammy White, so he just threw it out of bounds. Claiborne, Raymond Claiborne, was covering Sammy White. The Vikings are faced with a 3rd and 9. They're trying to end up the season on a positive note. They've won 3 of their last 4. That loss was in an overtime game. The Rams are now playing their best football of the season. And if they win today, the Vikings would wind up the season 8-8.
It's surprising that they would try to throw a play-action pass on 2nd and 9. Normally, they're not going to be fooled too much in that situation with play-action, and they really were not fooled, and that's why he had a hard time getting the ball off on 2nd and 9. Now it's 3rd and 9.
Kramer is operating with 3 wide receivers. 3rd and 9. That pass, he has him, and out of bounds in Patriot territory is Terry LeCount, number 80, second-year NFL player. Prentiss McCrane, a strong safety, knocked him out of bounds.
A simple pocket pass. They pick up the blocking up front in good shape. There was a blitz on the play. He stayed in the pocket nicely, threw the ball outside to Terry LeCount, number 80, made the catch. First down, Minnesota.
Oh, this is the first time the Vikings have had the ball. Atlanta 3, San Francisco nothing. And the story of that game, O.J. Simpson making his last appearance ever as a player in the National Football League. Now, 2 great ones retire today. Jim Marshall here and O.J. Simpson, Atlanta. Overthrew the pass, and Raymond Claiborne nearly grabbed it, number 26, intended for Sammy White. 2nd down. 10 to go. Vikings ball on the New England Patriot 45-yard line. Well, OJ's leaving with some class, Hank. He's been a bench warmer this year. And he said the coach, Bill Walsh, he's got to get this team for the future, not worry about me. And if I were him, I'd do the same thing. Been a gentleman all his years in the National Football League. And I didn't broadcast Jim Brown in person, but I've never broadcast a better running back than O.J. Simpson.
Well, he's been all pro in every category as a football player and as a person, and you have to congratulate him for the way he's handled himself in this situation this year.
Looking down, they're trying to screen pass to Ricky Young. Young's out on the Patriot 38-yard line, driven out by Steve Nelson. I'll never forget the first game O.J. ever played was in Buffalo. I did that game. He was stopped that day by the New York Jets, except on kickoff returns, and they used him out as a wide receiver quite a bit. In fact, his first year, they didn't give him the ball enough, I didn't think, of the running back.
Well, we tried desperately to try to get him when I was in Kansas City that year because they were using him a lot as a receiver. We thought maybe we had a chance to get him, and there was some discussion about it, but it never did develop and materialize, but he'd already been super with our club, just like he was for Buffalo.
3rd down, 3. Vikings on their Patriot 38. No score in this game. 6:27 to go in the first period. They'll try the short one, and he has the first down. He hits the back coming out, Ricky Young, who slithered right through the middle and is brought down by John Zamberlin, the linebacker.
You know, Kramer's got a good concept of the passing game. He gets it back there nicely, throws the ball into the seams. Ricky Young just anchored in the area between the linebackers. He was open. It's a possession style of passing. Very bright, very intelligent, but he got a lot of poise, and he knows exactly what he's doing, what he wants to do, and it does a good job with it.
Baltimore over the Giants, 7-0 first period. All right, the Vikings have a first down on the New England 29-yard line.
186.
They send Brown out. The pass incomplete. Intended for Brown. Slapped down by Julius Adams. It'll be 2nd down, 10. Kramer has hit 55% of his passing attempts this year, 22 touchdowns. He's had 23 intercepted.
And he's been sacked 36 times, which is an awful lot for a Minnesota team, especially a quarterback who moves as well as he does.
He is the 2nd Viking quarterback to ever pass for more than 3,000 yards in a season. Van Tarkenton, of course, the first one.
They're all up there tight. He tried to change the play in the line of scrimmage, but they changed the coverage, and he throws underneath. A nice play.
Ricky Young has it on the 21-yard line. Pulled down by Ray Kostic, playing in place of the injured Sam Hunt.
They faked the blitz that time, and Kramer changed the play. and changed the read, had plenty of time to throw the ball, throws underneath to Ricky Young, who makes the catch and his tackle there. And now we have a third and three situation.
Vikings ball on the Patriot 22. The Viking drive that started on her own 20-yard line. Out he goes again. He just, there he is, to the 10, Rashad to the 5. His forward motion stopped at the 4. And the Vikings will have first and goal to go. He got away from Ray Claiborne, and then it was Tim Fox who finally stopped it.
It was a simple outside pattern. Threw it in front of Ray Claiborne, number 26. He makes, tries to make the tackle, does not get his arms wrapped around him like he should. For that reason, Rashad is able to run inside and down to about the 4-yard line. A beautiful play. Kramer to Rashad.
First and goal to go for the Vikings. Frank Myers in at left tackle. Rashad needed 48 yards in this game to become the Vikings' all-time yardage pass receiver. Ooh, it was a great hit by Nelson on Ricky Young. Nelson was coming behind the line of scrimmage on the snap and got to it.
Yeah, they have a lot of respect for that defense. They run a counterplay in this situation. And watch Steve Nelson, number 57. He really comes through there. A great hit, hits him high right at the numbers. She slips away, but he does the damage when he made the initial contact.
He's made about 80% of the tackles for the Patriots so far.
And as I mentioned earlier, it's amazing he hasn't made the all-pro team.
Second down, 4 to go for a Viking touchdown. Rollout, Kramer. Hits Robert Miller, number 35, who's pulled down short of the goal line by rookie Rick Stanford, the Patriots' number one pick, and Tim Fox. They're going to spot the ball on the 1-yard line. Third down, a yard to go for a Viking touchdown. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. The 15th play for the Vikings in this drive. Pitt Brown's back in as a running back, number 23.
Looks like they're going to run left.
Patriots digging in. Straight ahead. It is a touchdown for Pitt Brown. Brown scores an 80-yard drive. A coach's dream on that drive. A long drive that used up a lot of time and play.
That time they had the left halfback way up in front of the fullback, which made it look like they were going to run left. They ran right up the middle. They got a good surge from their offensive line. Good blocking at the point of attack with Swilly, Hamilton, Poe. But they did a good job, and they have a touchdown. Lead this game 6-0 with 2:52 left in the first quarter.
Rick Danmeyer for the point. It is up, and the kick is good. Well, that's an 80-yard drive. And the score, late in the first period, the Vikings 6 and New England 0. 6-0 Vikings, first period. That's the scoring drive. Over 6 minutes. Boy, you coaches like those kind of drives, don't you?
Well, you don't have to worry about playing defense when you keep the ball that long.
That's the best defense in the world. Dan Meyer's kickoff. Alan Clark waiting on the 16, up to the 20. 25, 30, breaks through, 35. Stumbles and then is brought down. The man that upset him was Robert Miller. All right, New England trailing as they go on the offense. They'll be on their own 38-yard line. Rogan's a quarterback. He has hit 49% of his passes, 26 touchdowns. Brian Sipe leads the entire NFL with 27. Play action. Lots of time, wide open. With Harold Jackson, 30, and out of bounds. Boy, was he open. He goes out on the Vikings 26. Tom Hannon drove him out.
They ran a nice play action pass that time, faking to the right, and Jackson came over from the right side all the way over into the middle area. Watch here. Grogan fakes to Ivory, goes back in the pocket, has good protection. Jackson is coming over from right to left. Hasselbeck is the tight end coming across short. But Jackson catches the ball in the zone area that was vacated by the safety man. Beautiful play.
Play covered 37 yards. Grogan right away. Goes right back to Jackson again. That's two in a row for Harold Jackson. He has averaged 21.7 yards a catch. In fact, Jackson and Morgan as a pair of wide receivers on one team for the number of catches and yardage ranked number one in the National Football League. And they now have first down and a goal to go on the Viking 7-yard line.
You know, they had good balance coming into this game. Morgan came into the game with 41 catches and Jackson with 40.
Calhoun and Ivory are the running backs. That's Ivory. He is short of the five. In on him was Dave Roller, the left tackle of the Vikings, number 76.
You know, I can't understand, Kirk. That's the second time they run right into the strength of the defense. The defense was overloaded. That way, he didn't change the play at the line of scrimmage and go to the other side, but ran right into the traffic and didn't succeed in making much yardage on the play for that reason.
They'll come up with a second down. Six to go for a touchdown. Minnesota leading 6-0. A minute 50 remaining in the first period. He's going to throw. He gets it out to Ivory. Catches the ball. He's in. Touchdown, Horace Ivory. He went right through the cornerback, John Turner. It didn't take the Patriots long to come back.
That time they were in a slot formation to the right. They got good depth. Ivory was open on the outside move. Ball was thrown nicely. Goes into the end zone. Is tackled, or hit, I should say, but it's too late by John Turner. But it's in for the touchdown.
They went 62 yards in four plays. The Vikings went 80 yards in 15 plays. John Smith will try the point. He has kicked 43 out of 46. Matt Kavanaugh, backup quarterback, holding, and the kick is up. And that kick puts the Patriots out in front. With a minute and 43 seconds remaining in the first period. And we'll be back here in Foxborough with a score. New England, a little rain starting to come down. New England 7 and Minnesota. John Smith will kick off for New England. First-year player Jimmy Edwards of Northeast Louisiana is deep for the Vikings and is coming to Edwards as he backpedals. The yard into the end zone, out to the 10, to the 15, spun around and racked up on his 20-yard line on a hard hit. Minnesota's ball, first down, the tackle by Bill Matthews.
And he really made a good old-fashioned hard-hitting tackle that time. Beautiful play by Bill Matthews, number 53.
Quick scoring drive, less than a minute for New England. They'll go back into the lead. Pittsburgh has just made an announcement that linebacker Jack Ham is out for the season, including the playoffs, with an ankle injury. You say one man can make a difference? When you lose Jack Ham, it makes a difference. Greatest outside linebacker in football. Smart player. Brief opening for Ted Brown, and that's it. It was plugged up. Now Lunsford from the side, slanted in to take him, along with number 59, second-year linebacker Mike Hawkins.
Trying to run a trap that time with a left guard trapping, and didn't do a good job of cleaning it out. But they did make 4 yards on the play.
Baltimore now has the Giants 10-0. You saw the 49ers move ahead of Atlanta. The Vikings have a second down 6 on their 24. We're in the last minute of play in the first period here in Foxborough, Massachusetts. And now it is getting overcast and rain. We may be having some snow here before this game is over. How the weather's changed. Ricky Young. He's in trouble and he's lost the yard. John Zamberlin, the linebacker, on the hit. However, Rod Schott was the man that penetrated and forced Young to change his direction.
Yeah, they tried to get outside quickly from the I formation. Schott really did a good job of responding to what he saw. He got up the field quickly. For that reason, the back had no chance whatsoever to make a move of any kind and was finally tackled and loses yardage on the play.
Third down 7. Vikings ball under 23. Prentice McRae has replaced one of the linebackers. The Patriots have five secondary backs. And there's the gun ending the first period. And a score in Foxborough, Massachusetts, with bad weather threatening. The New England Patriots 7 and the Minnesota Vikings 6. Jim Ringo was a player in the trenches under the late Vince Lombardi, then with the Eagles, the head coach of Buffalo. Now a line coach here. He's watching the clubs open the second quarter. Vikings have the ball on their 23-yard line, 3rd and 7. They have 3 wide receivers on the field. They're going deep, and it is nearly intercepted by Mike Haynes, who is trying to take the ball away from Sammy White. Vikings must catch.
He was with him that time, step for step. Here you see Kramer throwing to the left side with the anticipation of getting the ball to Sammy White. It's thrown a little bit on the inside of the field, and for that reason, Haynes had a great chance to make a play on the ball.
Fourth down, punt formation. Greg Coleman now has the wind at his back. Stanley Morgans is deep for New England. Fair catch called by Morgans. It is out of bounds. It'll go out on the New England 36-yard line where they have a first down.
Morgan was lucky it took that kind of a bounce. He should have signaled for the fair catch and made the play. Ordinarily, if you don't make those plays, why, you can lose anywhere from 10 to 15 yards, especially so the way the ball bounces on synthetic turf.
We're early in the second period with New England leading the Minnesota Vikings 7-6. Hi, Vikings. Welcome to New England. They've been working out in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, since Wednesday of this past week. What a change. They arrived in Boston yesterday afternoon. Now we're getting some snow. Grogan on the screen. It is incomplete to Calhoun. Nearly a lateral pass, but not quite. Second down 10. The Patriots ball under 36.
Did you see how quickly the Minnesota team reacted to that ball? It might have been a lateral pass. Calhoun did not respond whatsoever, which was a bad mistake. It could have been a lateral, and of course, had it been recovered, Minnesota would have had possession, 1st and 10.
Famous lateral in the championship game the year that the Jets went to the Super Bowl, that Charlie Smith, who let the ball lie around, and Baker of the Jets recovered it to wrap up a Oakland drive to give the Jets the championship to move down and beat the Colts in Super Bowl III. That is Horace Ivory, ex of Oklahoma, trying to cut back. He's to his 38, and that's it. James White, the right tackle of Oklahoma State. Jim Duck White, his 4th year with the Vikes.
Jim Hanna, John Hanna that time, the left guard, pulled and really made a super block on the outside. There was too much traffic coming from the inside, however. Watch Hanna, the left guard. He's pulling to the outside. Ivor is following. Watch this block on the outside. If you don't get a good picture of it. Ivory cuts inside, gets caught in the traffic, doesn't make much on the play.
3rd and 8, 3 wide receivers on for the Patriots. Calhoun catches the ball, but he fumbled, but I believe the whistle had blown. They had it. No, they got a 1st down on it. Curtain off there. And what are they going to rule now? They rule a Patriot 1st down on the fumble.
He throws that ball away to Calhoun, got it there in perfect shape. The ball was knocked loose that time, but he jumped on it, recovered, and made a 1st down.
Somebody has bad feet. New England's ball under 47 with a 1st down. They're ahead by a point. That's Calhoun diving off his right guard, nudging into Viking territory with the Viking 49, upended by Dave Roller. They may put him on the 50. Let's put it on the 50. Make it 2nd down 7. And they have the towel out. It's a cross between a snow and a little light rain right now. This ball is going to get slipperier as the game moves along. 2nd and 7. 50-yard line is the scrimmage. Draw play, no way. Tom Hannon, the safety man, smelled that one out on Horace Ivory. Popped right in there on him.
Looked like he was blitzing on the play. He got an awful good jump on the ball that time.
And Studwell was in there also to aid him. Now it's back to the New England 46. They have a third down and 11. Hasselbeck leaves the game to tight end. Westbrook, a wide receiver, replaces him. They'll spread three fleet wide receivers out again. And five secondary backs on the field for the Vikings. 7-6, New England. 12 minutes to play in the first half. Fast moving game, by the way. Grogan, 6 out of 8 already. Look out. 72 jump, James White. And if he touched somebody, it's encroachment, violating the neutral zone. With a 5-yard penalty against the Vikings. Unless he's drawn off.
What?
Well, that's against the Vikings. Chuck White, number 72.
I think he tried to anticipate the cadence and the count and guessed wrong that time, and for that reason jumped offside.
Encroachment, number 72. Defense, third down.
How much did you work on that line, both the offensive line and the defensive line, getting a jump on the ball?
Well, the big thing is that you have to change the cadence offensively and defensively, because if you don't, the defense kind of gets the rhythm and they create a lot of problems. They get off the ball quicker than the offense.
Again. On the 3rd and 6, everything messed up. Dave Roller that time moving. And also White.
We kept track of what the cadence was on the sideline so we could show it to the quarterback when he got off the field to say, listen, you've been going on 2 too much, or going on 3 too much, or maybe 1 too much. You've got to change it. And but that's very important any time that you play.
I think Bob Greasy was one of the best at changing the cadence, the up and downs of his voice. Of course, you can't bob your head there. You can't draw him off by a head bob.
Yeah, that's right. But you're right about Bob Greasy. He is really a master at making you jump, especially on short yardage situations.
Who else was good that you saw?
Well, he was one of the best, I think, who really worked at it. Landry of Detroit was also another good one who did a good job with that.
It's Pedley going against Minnesota. It's changing the strategy now. They did have a 3rd and 11. Let's listen here. Maybe. Vikings are arguing. Matt Blair, 59, who has been a bright spot for the Vikings all year. Bud Grant said he's had a standout season. 6-year linebacker from Iowa State. Blair, very consistent. Kind of day like this, Hank, that the Vikings are going to appreciate that new dome stadium right in downtown Minneapolis. 1982. What a boost that's going to be for those two outstanding.
We have a false start, left tackle, encroachment, defense, replay.
Offsetting penalty. False start, Pete Brock, and it's wiped out.
You know, I think it's going to hurt Minnesota artistically more than it'll help them, because they won a lot of games under that adverse condition up there in Minnesota in that cold weather and snow and sleet. Playing inside all the time will be an advantage for the people who visit Minnesota to play them.
I'd still rather be indoors.
Yeah, as a fan, I would. That's right.
3rd and 6. I think it's going to be great.
I think it will be, too.
3rd and 6. 49-yard line of the Vikings. Going to help the Twins, too. Grogan throws under pressure. Nearly grabbed off by Matt Blair. Pass intended for Horace Ivory. Dave Roller had a big pass rush on Grogan, and now it's 4th and 6 for New England, and they'll have to go into a punt formation.
You know, it's amazing the fact that the New England team has been sacked 48 times with a quarterback who moves as well as Grogan. It's hard to believe that they've had that many sacks.
Well, Grogan's been sacked 12 times in the last 3 games, 5 times last week against the Jets. Kevin Miller is the safety man. The kick is a short one. He'll chase it to the sideline. It goes out of bounds. Patriots have had trouble with their punting. They've had only one punter in the last 10 years who's averaged better than 40 yards or more. We're going to be back here in Foxborough with a score, New England 7 and Minnesota 6. My 17th game in a row with the dapper one, the dapper little mentor, Hank Stram. I hope we have many more together, Hank.
Yeah, I hope so. It's been a lot of fun, Kurt.
Great.
It's been
great.
Super.
Let's get to the game here. Vikings ball on their own 22. They're trailing 7-6. have 11:36 to go in the first half. Ricky Young, Ted Brown at the running back. Tommy Kramer, wide open, and flips it away. And going down on the 31-yard line is Ted Brown. Brown, a dog with some injuries there for a stretch. Number one draft pick. He gained over 531 yards. He looks like a good one for the future. Monday night on CBS, WKRP in Cincinnati. Great radio station. The Last Resort, MASH, House Calls, and then Lou Grant. Monday night on CBS.
Second and two, another passing formation. Let's see what they do. Now they run.
Trying to send Ricky Young for that first down, but he ran into Mike Hawkins and John Zamberlin, a couple of young linebackers. Young is a leading ground gainer this year for Minnesota, over 600 yards. Average not too outstanding, 3.6, three touchdowns. They're looking to the far sideline, and they say the Vikes have the first down.
I'm talking about Ricky Young, he came into the game with 57 catches. Boy, that's a lot of passes.
He comes out of that backfield well. We have some outstanding players here in this field that'll be in the Pro Bowl. For the Patriots, John Hanna, the guard, Morgan, the outside man, and Haynes, the cornerback. Vikings are going to send Ahmad Rashad and Matt Blair to the Pro Bowl game, representing Minnesota. So five players on the field will be in the Pro Bowl game. That's the all-star team. Kramer to the safety valve man. Ricky Young crawling after he reached the 40, went forward to his 42. Steve Nelson brought him down. Kramer's very good at finding that safety valve man.
Yeah, I was just going to say that. You know, he sent Brown in motion and was going to try to hit him deep, but he was covered well, went back to the other side, had enough time to make the adjustment and throw the ball short to Ricky Young, number 34, who saved the play, and now is second and one.
And they have a short yard. Steve Grogan, the New England quarterback, he's up and down in the eyes of affection with the New England fans week to week. They take it to Young. Kramer is throwing deep to White, and it's broken up there by Raymond Claiborne, the left cornerback, who was right with Sammy White.
Yes, White went outside, inside, and tried to fool him with moves downfield on the play-action pass. But Claiborne really did a good job of staying with him. He had to throw the ball on the run, didn't have much on it. The ball was thrown a little bit to the inside again, but Claiborne really did a good job on the play.
Vikings have a third and one. Robert Miller, a tough short yardage man, number 35, comes in. Ted Brown goes out. Vikings have the ball on their own 42-yard line. New England's ahead in the game, 7-6. A little over 9 minutes to play in the first half. Young has the call. And he is brought down by Ricky Samford. It's a first down for the Vikings on the 44-yard line.
Looks like he might be calling home.
That's Harold Jackson. Mom, I caught a couple earlier. Stay tuned. I believe he's calling the weatherman. They may be asking for his gloves.
Or either that or calling for reservations to get out of town right after the game.
Hey, that's more likely than anything. Vikings ball first down on their own 44. Miller peeling out in motion.
He likes to throw a lot on first down. That time he runs a draw play.
Big play for Ricky Young. He's in the Patriot territory and a lot more, all the way to the Patriot 29. Before he's upended by Mike Haynes and Rick Samford. Perfectly executed draw.
That's a sprint draw. It looks like he's going to roll out to the right, but he gives the ball to the tailback. Ricky Young finds a nice seam inside, got the linebackers running out of there, made a beautiful run on the play.
I love to see those backs with quick feet pick their way through prostrate bodies as they go through that hole.
Well, it makes it a lot easier to get through there if you have quick feet.
Pittsburgh leading Buffalo 14-0. The Steelers are in the playoffs anyway, but we'll give you all the possibilities. Here's Terry LeCount, who falls down. This was a lateral to LeCount, who was going to throw a forward pass, I believe, to Ahmad Rashad, but he He lost his footing, and the play backfires on the Vikings.
And it didn't fool the defense of the New England team at all. Fakes inside, fakes to Young, tosses the ball back to LeCount. Kind of a recess football play.
Pump fake?
Yeah, there it is, and they slipped and fell safe into second base.
I don't believe Terry wanted to throw the ball.
No, I don't think he did. He shouldn't have thrown it because there's nobody covered. Nobody open, I should say. Everybody was covered.
They have a second down now in 19. Ricky Young and Robert Miller, the running back. Now Kramer go back in the air again. The receiver lost the ball. Mike Haynes, all-pro cornerback, jarred it loose from Sammy White. You can see why Haynes is an all-pro player.
Yes, he really came up. It looked like he was going to be able to make the catch. But Haynes gave him a good shot in the back and jarred the ball loose. The ball was thrown a little bit behind again. Had it been thrown right at the numbers, he couldn't have made that kind of a play.
Incidentally, that sack on LeCount was the Patriots' 57th of the year, which is one short of their club record set in 1977. And they lead the National Football League in sacks this year. Ted Brown's back in the lineup for the Vikings. Third and 19. Going deep, wide open is White. And it's loose again. Mike Haynes, a remarkable play because White was open. I don't know how Mike Haynes got to him.
That's what you call excellent recovery speed. White was open. The ball was in the air a long time. It looks like he's going to be able to make the catch. But here again, it's thrown a little bit to the outside, Kurt, instead of right at him or to the inside. Had it been thrown inside, he would have been able to make the play. You have to give Haynes a lot of credit for the good response that he had on the thrown ball.
Greg Coleman will punt. Shanks it. Still may have a good kick. It is in for the touchback. And the Patriots will take over on their own 20-yard line for the first down. And the clock shows 6 minutes and 40 seconds to play in the first half. Foxborough, Massachusetts, New England leading 7-6. Preceding message brought to you the public service by the National Football League and CBS. See that Kavanaugh's number one? That's Matt Kavanaugh, All-American from Pittsburgh. But he's having knee problems. He had knee surgery when they drafted him, and now the other knee has been operated on.
And it's funny, the fans always want the quarterback who's sitting on the bench.
Brogan, beautiful fake, throwing deep, incomplete to Stanley Morgans, who has averaged 24 yards a catch this year, tops in the National Football League. Wesley Walker was leading, but he became injured halfway through the year.
Play action pass from the I formation. Morgan was covered deep, double covered into the hole. Jackson was wide open coming across the middle like he was on a preceding play. He didn't see him, didn't look for him, and threw into the coverage, and it fell incomplete.
49ers back out in front in the race to see who's going to get the derby for the number one pick, the Lions or the 49ers. A lot of talk now that Buddy, you should know. We'll talk about that in a minute. Second down, 10. Brogan sideline pass. And out of bounds is Harold Jackson with it. Yeah, he may have the first down. He took that ball in front of the cornerback, John Turner.
That's the third pass they've thrown in front of Turner, and they succeeded in making big yardage each time they have thrown on his side.
Hank Stram coached a guard named Ed Buddy. For years he played for you. Came out of Michigan State, right?
Yes, he was a great guard and all-leaguer, and we watched young Brad grow up in the confines of our training camp and facility in Kansas City, and he's growing up to be one of the great guards in the country at Southern California, and surely a number one pick.
Yes, he short plunge there by Calhoun. Many think that they're switching now. All the experts, they thought Sims might go as the number one pick. Depends what a team needs. And now a lot of people are saying that whoever gets the number one pick should draft Brad Buddy, who's one of the greatest blocking offensive linemen USC's ever had.
Well, his dad was one of the very best in the business, and of course, when you draft a person number one, you want to make sure that he's going to be able to play for you for at least 10 years, like Ed Buddy did for us, and so I'm sure that they're going to consider Brad very strongly.
Brogan throwing in the snow, incomplete to the tight end, Don Hazelback. Second down, 10. Tommy Jackson with that, Harold Jackson with that last catch. It just tied Tommy McDonald for ninth place on the all-time NFL receiving list. Harold Jackson. He's having one of his best years this season, the veteran. Snowing and raining. I thought there'd be no show, more no shows today. With not much at stake except pride here today. Second down, 10 to go. New England under 33. They're leading by a point. That's Calhoun cutting back. Calhoun is at the 40, and there he stopped. He'll be about 3 yards short of the first down. Dave Roller was there. Jeff Seaman, the middle linebacker. Standout player ever since he came off the Stanford campus and joined the Vikings.
Grogan did a good job of keeping Minnesota off balance that time in an obvious passing situation, ran the ball and was able to make 8 yards on the play, third and two.
You know, you're right, Hank. Look at that. Fourth in offense, number one in the league in defense, and yet they're not in the playoffs.
Yeah, that's really an incredible statistic. Along with the fact that they have been sacked 48 times, that's really incredible.
Third down and three. Grogan throwing wide. He was under the gun. He had number 54, Fred McNeil, in there blitzing him, and Scott Studwell. Blitzing linebackers on Grogan. Watch them.
They guessed right on that. This is the first time he's rolled out in the game. He started to stumble there, but Fred McNeil, 54, was blitzing from the inside and did a good job. He threw the ball poorly with nothing on it.
Fourth down, Eddie Hare. Punt formation. Kevin Miller, the safety man. Wobbly kick, not a very good one. Takes a Viking bounce and is downed on the 37-yard line of the Vikings. Patriots getting poor punting in this game. Alan Clark down. And is getting miserable now in New England. With 4:55 to go in the first half. New England 7, Minnesota 6. Young Tommy Kramer, the man of the future for the Vikings, has already put the ball up 20 times in the first half. Completed 10, most of them short passes. Vikings are a little bit different mold right now. They're a wide-open team, Hank. They throw it around.
Yes, they do, but they did a lot of that with Fran, and
yeah.
He's got a good understanding of what they're trying to accomplish with the kind of a pass possession kind of offense.
Well, I was thinking of the old Purple Eaters game, People Eaters. That's Ted Brown out of bounds. They're gone. Carl Eller, that was nice of Eller. Eller came back last Sunday in Marshall's last home game to be there. They played together many times, Cleveland and Cincinnati, 6-6 in the second. Marshall was given permission by Seattle to come back for the occasion. Jim Marshall's teammates carried him off the field at the end of the game. Last home game, 20 years with the Vikings. First down Vikings on the Patriot, 48-yard line. Vikings are trailing by a point, 7-6. Sammy White in motion. They run the draw play to Ted Brown. They don't get much on it because Rod Schoate plugged up the gap along with Julian Adams, the right end. We were talking about those sacks of the Patriots, one short of their all-time club record, and they lead the NFL. The all-time NFL record for most sacks in a season by a team was by Oakland. They had 67 in a 14-game schedule back in 1967. That's getting to the quarterback a lot.
Looks like a lot of screen passes.
Second down, 10. Kramer has him spread all over. Shoots it down the middle. He has Sammy White for a first down. Sanford wrapped White up at the New England 34-yard line. 3:55 remaining in the first half.
You know, Tommy Kramer throws the ball on first and 10 as much as any quarterback in the league. And really puts a lot of pressure on the defense and avoids that obvious long passing situation. Here he is back in the pocket. Plenty of time to throw the ball. Throws it nicely right down the middle to Sammy White, right on the numbers. And another big play for Minnesota.
First down, Vikings ball in the 34. 12 out of 22 for Kramer, who broke all the passing records at Rice University. Number one pick. Get him ready for the future after talking to him. Got pump fake. They're on him. He throws it away and got rid of it. Smart play by Kramer. Steve King rushing him. And he dumped it off without having intentional grounding calling.
There's a great illustration of the kind of poise he has. He tried to fake the quick screen and throw it deep downfield, but there you see Steve King coming in from the backside. He still has enough poise and composure to get rid of the ball falling away and avoided a big loss on the play.
Second down, 10. Vikings behind, 7-6, 3:14 remaining in the first half. Rainy day, a little snow mixed in with it here in New England. Rolls it out to the sideline. Hey, a remarkable catch with that wet ball at the 28 of New England by Ahmad Rashad, who's gone over 1,000 yards in receiving and caught 9 touchdown passes this year.
He was trying to get Rashad to go deep, but Rashad didn't see it and responded to the outside. He got the ball right where it had to be. There you see him rolling to the right, throws the ball on the move, and Rashad makes a diving catch for the football.
We've had quite a few 1,000-yard receivers this year. Largent, Stallworth, Jefferson, Lewis in the AFC. Third down. Good pass out to Ted Brown. Brown has stopped at the 21 of New England. That's enough for a Minnesota first down. Mike Hawkins nipped him around the ankle.
He read the coverage again very well. They doubled the outside receiver, which meant that he had to go either to his tight end or back in the flat. Mike Hawkins was covering on the play, number 59.
1,000 yards in a year is a hallmark for a receiver, just like a running back. And over in the National Conference, they have Rashad, Drew Pearson, and Wes Chandler with at least 1,000 yards. We're going to be back for the final 2 minutes of the half, 7-6 in favor of New England. We just had a roar while we were away. It's for the cheerleaders who disappeared at the kickoff and just came back for the first time. What's a football game without cheerleaders? They didn't like the weather, Henry.
I can't believe them. It just shows that they're very intelligent.
Always said NFL cheerleaders were intelligent. We have a first down. Vikings ball on the New England 21. 7-6 to score. New England leading. 2 minutes to play and a half. Good protection for Kramer. Runs out of the pocket. 20, 15, 10, still going, 5. Down on the 3-yard line by Rick Sanford. First and goal to go for Minnesota.
That's the one thing about the double cover. They double cover the outside receiver. When you double cover the outside receivers, the middle is open if you get a chance to take it. He saw it and took off, went through the traffic, knew exactly where he had to go, what he had to do. And is finally tackled there by Rick Sanford, number 25.
Well, he's quite a ball carrier today. He's averaged 16 yards a carry, 32 yards and 2 carries. First and goal to go, Minnesota. That's plugged up at the 2-yard line. Ted Brown trying to crack it over, couldn't do it. Second down, 2 to go. Vikings on the New England 2. They're letting that clock move along. It's down to 1 minute to play and a half. Now they bring Robert Miller on. Brown goes out. Miller, the fifth-year player from the University of Kansas. 45 seconds to go in the half. Second and 2 for a Viking touchdown.
Looks like something right or up the middle.
It is right with Miller. He'll be in. Robert Miller scores. And the Vikings, with 34 seconds remaining in the half, move ahead. Excellent drive, spearheaded by young Tommy Kramer. Here it is, Miller rolling right. He had the blocking. All he had to do was just steam into that end zone. Wide open for
him. It was an option run for him. Either he runs inside or outside. He saw the outside wide open, took advantage of it, jumped to the outside, went into the end zone unmolested for the touchdown.
And Meyer's kick is up. And it's good. He missed his first extra point attempt. 34 seconds and a half. And the Vikings lead. 13-7. 4 years ago, a giant American chemical company was told by one of its own engineers that it was slowly contaminating water wells adjoining the plant. Did the company do anything about it? Watch 60 Minutes tonight, right after football. Vikings will boot it off. They're trying to finish this season on the upbeat, winning three of their last four, while the Patriots have lost four of their last five. Dan Meyer from Sioux Falls will kick off. Alan Clark, Northern Arizona's deep. In the last 2 minutes, the clock will not start until the ball is touched in the field of play, not when it is kicked. Now the clock starts. The 18-yard line. Don Westbrook took it. Tries to head for the sideline and is downed on his 30-yard line with 29 seconds to go. Tackle made by Kurt Knopf of the Vikings. Don Westbrook again to the 31-yard line. Steve Grogan comes out. Hasselbeck, a tight end, leaves the field, so evidently, they're going wide open with three wide receivers trying to get a quick score here, Hank, of the last 29 seconds of the half. Jackson's to the right. Stanley Morgan's a deep burner to the left. It's over to Morgan's. He comes up to the 40, still going, cross to the 45. He's in bounds and stopped at his 47-yard line with the clock moving. And now to stop. Possibly the Patriots calling a time with 16 seconds to go in the half. Morgan has now gained 1,000 yards receiving this season. He is the first Patriot to ever do this, and his yardage right now is 1,004. Stanley Morgan's over the 1,000 mark on that last pass play.
That's really the nice thing about Morgan and Jackson, both of whom are excellent receivers, but in conjunction with that, they have the great ability to run extremely well once they make the catch.
Steady rain coming down. A little snow mixed in with it. We could have a wild second half here with some freakish things happening. Vikings are used to this. They, over the years, have been famous for playing in bad weather and persevering.
Yes, and they've played extremely well in bad weather and under adverse conditions.
Bud Grant, I talked to him last night, Hank. He's going on four hunting trips. He's going down to Oklahoma, Texas, Mexico, and he said he loves the outdoors. He's a great fisherman and hunter. He's the first time not in the playoff. He's going to coach in the Senior Bowl game, the North team. Ray Perkins will coach the other club. And you and I will be there for the telecast of that game.
Well, the back is wide open.
It's right into the hands of the Viking player, Kurt Knopf. Knopf is tackled and brought down on his 32-yard line. Intended for Don Westbrook.
Well, the back coming underneath that time was wide open. He never took a look at him at all. Just tried to throw the ball deep downfield. Had no chance whatsoever. Had plenty of time. But Ivory, coming across the middle, was really open on the play.
That is the first turnover of the first half. Westbrook came back. He was the intended receiver to make the tackle. 9 seconds remaining in the first half. Minnesota has taken the lead 13-7 in the last minute of this half with a well-executed drive guided by Tommy Kramer.
He's just going to lay in the ball, I think. It looks like they're just satisfied to...
They're all starting for the dressing rooms. And the first half is about to end in Foxborough, the last regular game of the season. Some of the fans here booing the Patriots. They're on them here. And the score at halftime from Foxborough, Massachusetts. Minnesota Vikings 13 and the New England Patriots 7. In the second half, we'll see what happens. The weather is worsening, and it's going to be a definite factor in the second half. New England win would wind them up at 8-8. And a loss would leave them. Well, they'd be 9-7. And a loss would leave them at 8-8. Been a sad windup for these New England fans. But they want to win today in the last run. Well, we'll see what happens. We're going to have halftime entertainment from the NFL today, and there's the halftime score.
In the NFC Central, the Chicago Bears have just scored on the St. Louis Cardinals on their first possession. It is now 7-0, and it is scoreless in Tampa Bay at the half. Let's take you now to the scoreboard. Minnesota leading New England. The game you've been watching, 13-7 is the score there at the half. San Francisco and O.J. Simpson's last game, leading Atlanta 14-10. DeBerg has thrown an 11-yard scoring pass to McAfee in that game. Baltimore shutting out the New York Giants 17-0 in the second period. The Pittsburgh Steelers are at it again. Bradshaw out with an injury, back to hand the ball off to Franco Harris, who banged in from a yard away. Earlier, Terry threw 19 yards to Lynn Swan. Cleveland and Cincinnati are tied at 6. Both teams missed extra points in that game. And at half, it is raining hard in Tampa. The Buccaneers must win this to wrap up the NFC Central. Both teams have missed field goals. Meanwhile, Chicago scored on a one-yard run by Walter Payton. Now, Jane, we've got some nostalgia today because Jim Marshall of the Minnesota Vikings is stepping down, and what a remarkable endurance record he's established.
A fantastic man. The very first game the Vikings ever played, he was there even though he had encephalitis. In his entire career, as a matter of fact, in the entire history of the Vikings franchise, he has played in and started in 302 games. Incredible.
This was his swan song today at New England, introduced to the crowd in Foxborough for the last time. Number 70, Jim Marshall. Not our only retirement. Down in Atlanta Fulton County Stadium, this man, the Juice, number 32, O.J. Simpson, trotting out for the last time in football attire.
The man that holds four NFL records, Brent, some of them which include the most yards gained in one season, the most games at 200 yards or more rushing, most touchdowns in one season.
Now to basketball. Dave DeBuscher, Willis Reed, Phil Jackson last night in Madison Square Garden because this man, Walt Frazier, returned. Number 10 was retired. It'll hang up there in the rafters with number 19, which Reed wore with distinction. And you can perhaps hear the crowd in the garden chanting, defense, defense. This was the team that won the NBA championship.
Great clutch player, Brent. Known as Mr. Fourth Quarter.
And then after that retirement, it was the New York Knicks and the Boston Celtics. And how good is Larry Bird? Well, let's take a look at him. Last night, he tossed in better than 30 points for Bill Fitch's Celtics against the Knicks. Now, I want you to watch Bird as he hits on the three-pointer. He'll be down at the bottom of your screen. Checks in position. He made 3 three-point shots in the game. 30 seconds to go. The Knicks are up 96-95. Boston says we got to play tough D, and Ray Williams runs to the trap in the corner. So on the double team, the ball will be stolen by ML Carr. It'll go to Don Chaney, and here comes the hoop that puts the Celtics ahead for good, 97-96. The Knicks will come right down. They'll bring it back as quickly as they can, and Ray Williams wants to get the ball to Bill Cartwright. Watch the defense inside by Dave Collins. Behind, he'll front the rookie from San Francisco, pressure him, and not allow that pass to come from Williams. The ball is stolen finally by Ford. He will go to Don Chaney. Last attempt coming up by Michael Ray Richardson. The Knicks are down by 3, and he came ever so close, but the Celtics win again, 99-96. Now let's check in on some NFL highlights. We've got the Minnesota-New England game. We've already told you about Jim Marshall stepping down after that fabulous career with the Minnesota Vikings. For a defensive lineman, just incredible that he has not ever missed a start in the history of that franchise. Here's Kramer to Rashad, and Ahmad has had a spectacular year. Inside the 5, and here's Teddy Brown, the rookie up over the top. Al Davis, Oakland, wanted to acquire him in a trade before the season began. Now here comes Grogan. Back to the former Ram, Jackson, over the middle. You tell me why the Patriots aren't going to the playoffs with all this talent. Here it is to Horace Ivory for the touchdown. Robert Miller scoring for the Vikings, and it is 13-7 at the half. Minnesota is ahead. And Irv, you've got some on San Francisco and Atlanta down south.
Hey, you know, the 49ers have lost 7 consecutive games. It's incredible. On the road. tying a league record. There's lead at halftime, of course, 14-10 right now down in Atlanta. And Steve DeBerg has thrown the ball more than anybody in the National Football League. In the first quarter goes to Paul Hofer, the running back taking O.J. Simpson's place. And Hofer scampers up the sideline down to the 30-yard line. DeBerg, keeping the ball in the air, goes with his tight end, number 81, Ken McAfee out of Notre Dame. Remember him, Brent? Great tight end. And Atlanta, San Francisco draws first blood. Bartkowski comes back with a pass, number 89, Francis Wallace, but interference was called on the defense, so Atlanta stays alive. At that point, number 24, Haskell Stanback, goes in for a touchdown, and it's 10-7, Atlanta. Hofer comes back with a handoff from DeBerg late in the second quarter and goes over, and at halftime, the 49ers are leading by a score of 14-10.
Let's go live to Soldier Field in Chicago. The Bears, with their second possession, are on the drive again. You're watching live. Walter Payton, number 34, he has been carrying the burden. He is down across the Cardinal 40-yard line. And so quickly to give you the story here, in the NFC Central, a Chicago win and a Tampa Bay loss would give the Bears the championship. Tampa Bay and Kansas City about ready to start the second half. They're scoreless. We're going to send you back to New England now. In the second half, Minnesota and the Patriots coming up.
Stay tuned as the NFL Today continues after this word from your local station. I'm raining 13-7. Minnesota took the lead, 46 seconds to go in that half. We could have a really bad weather here in the second half. Some of the fans have moved back undercover. Hank, we've got just a little time here. I thought it might be interesting for you to run down with me a sentence or two on every club that probably is going to be in the playoffs and give me your capsule opinion of them. The Steelers are going to be in it. What about the Steelers?
Well, I still think they're the finest team in professional football, and I'll be very surprised if they're not back in the Super Bowl.
Cleveland.
Well, Cleveland's got a very remote possibility. I think Sam Bertigliano has done an excellent job with his team, but, you know, it's going to be very tough for them to get in the playoffs.
Chicago Bears still have a chance.
Yes, they have, depending on what happens with Tampa this afternoon. We don't know anything about those two games at this stage of the afternoon, so we have to reserve a judgment on that until afterwards.
And later on CBS, Washington and Dallas. How about those two teams?
Well, there again, that's going to be a jump ball situation. You don't know who's going to win the game, but I still think that Dallas will somehow, some way, be involved in the Super Bowl.
What about the Rams? They're in for sure.
Yes, they're in for sure, and they're going to be a little bit better than I think people have given them credit for being, especially so because they're a good team defensively. They're having trouble offensively, and that could be a problem.
Oakland has a shot at a wild card.
Yeah, they have an outside chance, too, and they're playing extremely good. I think Tom Flores has done an excellent job with the Oakland Raiders, but they still have a chance.
Philadelphia, Houston.
I think here again, between those two teams, that's a jump ball thing, too. Any one of the two teams could win.
There's the halftime score here in New England, 13-7 Vikings. The Minnesota Vikings lead New England as we go into the second half. It has just about stopped raining now. We had a deluge at halftime that drove many of the fans away and undercover, and then suddenly the skies lightened up, and this is the best it's been now in about a quarter and a half. New England in the darker red jersey, the Vikings in the white. Interconference play, the Vikings this year have won one and lost two to the American Conference. They beat Buffalo last week, lost to the Jets and the Dolphins earlier. Since the merger, the Vikings have won 18 and lost 12 to the American Conference. Patriots are 2-1 against the NFC this year. They've beaten the Bears and the Lions while losing to Green Bay, and they're 16-13 against the NFC since the merger.
You know, so far in this game, Kurt, Minnesota's kind of dominated the game from a time standpoint also, along from with a statistical standpoint. They've had the ball for 19 minutes and 43 seconds compared to New England's 10 minutes and 17 seconds. They have 116-yard passing. They've thrown 25 times. New England, 8 of 15 for 116. Total yards, Minnesota, 192, and New England, 135. You know, going into this game, the Minnesota Vikings have averaged 33 passes a game and 31 runs. And so they're a little ahead of their average from a passing standpoint because they've already thrown 25 times in the first half.
I think one of the amazing stats of the game has been only one turnover in the rain and the snow. And that was an intercepted pass that Grogan threw. Vikings will kick off. Dan Meyer's boot bounding around. Westbrook fumbles it on the 20, out to the 25, and he goes down on his 28 or 29 yard line. But the Patriots now will start the second half in their own territory. They'll have Grogan at quarterback, Horace Ivory, and Don Calhoun as a running back. Sam Cunningham injured today. Will not play. Russ Francis, another one of their stars with a head injury, is out. 29-yard line of the Patriots, first down. He'll throw right away in the opening play of the half. It is incomplete to Harold Jackson. Second down, 10. Individually in this game, in the stats. In the pass receiving, Ricky Young caught 5, Ted Brown 3, Ahmad Rashad 3. Jackson caught 3 for the Patriots. He leads in yardage with 64. Ground gaining, Ricky Young the leader for the Vikings with 36. Calhoun had 20. Look at the Bears over the Cardinals, 14-0 first period. Calhoun bucking his way to the 32-yard line of the Patriots. Third down, 7.
Talking about the Bears, a terrible shock to hear about Muggsy Hallis.
Son of George Hallis.
Yes. 54 years old. Very sad to hear that about Muggsy.
Incidentally, the Bears must win and Tampa Bay must lose to Kansas City for Chicago to capture the NFC Central. The Bears lose or out of the division race no matter what happens. They're ahead right now.
If they throw, they ought to throw in front of 27. If they can. No, he's got caught back in the pocket.
Grogan's out to the 34 and a half, and it'll be a fourth down.
They've thrown in front of Turner, number 27, several times in the game. The receiver has been open. I thought perhaps they might go to him in that situation, but he didn't have an opportunity to get rid of the ball.
Eddie Hare, averaging 36 yards a punt today, which is his seasonal average. Kevin Miller's back deep. Miller waiting. Takes it on the 28. With a 30. Surrounded by red-shirted Patriots. And he's stopped at the Viking 34 by Steve King. Vikings first down. Hank, two more teams I want to ask you about. Your capsule summaries to round up your analysis of the postseason possibilities. You'll be out in San Diego tomorrow night. Denver and San Diego. What do you think about each one of those teams?
Well, both of them, you know, they're extreme personalities. Denver is a super team defensively. San Diego has excellent balance, but it's hard to understand how a team can go all the way without a better running attack than San Diego. Perhaps they can, but they do everything well except run the football.
Ricky Young. Young to the 36, a pickup of 3, second and 7. Richard Bishop made the stop. Ricky Young has handled the ball around 340 plays this year and has fumbled only twice. That's the fewest fumbles among National Football Conference running backs. He's handled the ball at least 200 times. Good man to give the ball to. Second and 7. 13-7, Vikings ahead early in the third period. Kurt Gowdy and Hank Stram here. Foxborough, Massachusetts. Sideline pass to Ricky Young. Scrambles back. They're going to blow him dead at the 41-yard line of the Vikings. Mike Haynes made the hit on him, the right cornerback.
I mentioned this early in the game, but I'll mention it again. Kramer really does a good job. He recognizes that they're double covering the outside receivers. He must get the ball to the tight end or the backs. He does just that time. Gets the ball out to Ricky Young, number 34, and he's just short of the first down, but that's the only way, only place he could throw the ball that time, and he found the right receiver.
They have a third down and 2. Minnesota on their 41-yard line.
They've thrown so much in this game so far, and I don't think they've thrown a ball yet to the tight end.
You're right. Blitz is on. Oh, he was hit as he let that ball go. Ricky Samford, a strong safety blitz coming on, and he escaped with his life, Kramer did, as he unloaded. Watch him.
He got a good jump on the ball that time. Here he comes. Hits him high. and there's no chance for him to get the ball to the receiver the way he was hit on that last play.
Fourth and two, punt formation with Greg Coleman. Stanley Morgan deep. The rain has stopped. Hits a wobbly kick. Morgan waiting on his 15, 20, 25. And he went backward. They'll spot the ball on the New England 24. The Patriots have a first down. And when we come back here to Foxborough with 11:42 to play in the third quarter, Vikings still lead 13-7. Bud Grant, hands jammed into his trousers, ranks third among the active coaches. Right there, with 122 career wins, Don Shula's won the most, and then Tom Landry. Horace Ivory nearly has his head taken off. He stopped at the 27-yard line of the Patriots. Ivory's first year when he came out of Oklahoma. He was injured most of the season. Tackles made by John Turner and Kurt Knopf. 28-yard line, a gain of four, give Ivory, second and six. Shula's won 175, Landry 171, and Bud Grant 122 career wins. And Bud won 102 games in Canada before coming to the NFL. George Halas is the all-time winner of 320. Ivory again. He nearly is tripped up, gets away to the 30, dives forward, stopped at the 33. Not too far from a first down.
A very simple sweep, running left. Starts to make a move inside, but continues to stay outside. Number 44, Tom Hannon, had a chance to make a play, but he cut inside. And is very close to the first down, but I don't think he's made it.
Looks like they'll have third down and a short yard to go. George Halas, as Hank Stram mentioned, lost his son today, Muzzy Halas. Imagine a man, Hank, winning 320 pro games as a head coach in 40 years of coaching. George Halas.
One of the all-time greats.
That's Bob Kreider of Alabama coming out, second-year offensive guard. Sam Adams going in. Hank had 131 wins, which is more than Bud Grant. But you're not active. You're an active broadcaster now.
An active spectator.
I get asked a lot, will you ever coach again?
It all depends, Kurt. I really don't know. I'm very happy doing what I'm doing, but, you know, you never know.
Well, that's a good answer. Calhoun has the first down. There's an old saying, never say never, right?
That's exactly right. It sounds very final.
The Patriots ball, first down. They're trailing in this game, 13-7. 10:15 to play in the third quarter, and the Patriots have the ball in their 36.
You know, it's unusual that Minnesota 13 against the rush, and that the Patriots haven't run the ball better, being the fifth rushing team in the league.
They have a hole open again for Calhoun as he squeezes his way just to the 40-yard line. 4-yard pickup for Calhoun, Kansas State. Second down, six. Patriots staying on the ground. Steve Grogan, number 14, down there on his haunches. Started his 64th straight game today. That's the most of any active quarterback in the league. Terry Bradshaw's next on the list with 46. Bradshaw missed quite a bit of time with injuries a couple of years. In and out. Play action pass.
Here comes Jackson.
Dropped it right in his hands, Harold Jackson. And ooh, he said, Harold, how could you do that? And Harold just answered, I did.
You know, they run that play. It's a play-action pass. They've run it on three occasions from different formations. Every time they've run it, Jackson has been very much open. That time he got the ball to him for the second time, and he dropped it. Another occasion he was open, but they threw the ball deep downfield into the post to Stan Morgan.
This game was not quite a sellout. About 4,000 short, and I was surprised many people showed up as dead, but when it rained really hard during the halftime, some have left. Three wide receivers on the field for New England.
With all the passing that we've seen here this afternoon, a tight end on either team has not caught the ball yet.
Third and six. They're after him. He can go. 40. Taking away. Trying to reach that yardstick, but he can't do it. And also trying to keep the ball. Mark Mullaney turned him down.
You know, one thing that I can't understand as I watch this New England team play, it's hard to understand why he doesn't roll out more than he does, Kurt, because that's one of the better things he does as a quarterback. He puts a lot of pressure on the defense, but we don't see him do that very often by design. He does it by necessity sometime, but very seldom by design.
Well, you might have thought earlier in the year, you know, he had the knee operation in the offseason, but his knee's been fine all year. Eddie Hare punting, Kevin Miller deep. Miller fair catches it on his own 18-yard line where the Vikings have the ball with the first down. The clock shows 8:27 remaining in the third period. Minnesota 13, New England 7. There's your score. Middle of the third period. Vikings took the lead with 46 seconds to go in a half. And it's not been a wild third quarter so far.
You know, Kramer, for a first-year man, is really very aggressive. He's on the attack. He throws so much on first and 10, but you have to be impressed with the kind of a job he's done.
He's throwing again on first down. Maybe. He does unload it, and it's incomplete. When Hank said a first-year man, what he meant was a first-year starter. He sat on the bench quite a bit. He's first 2 years in the league with a learning and watching process that these young quarterbacks seem to have to go through. Two things I've learned this year working with Hank Stram. One is where to carry the ball. And secondly is it's great to throw on first down. You love to see a club throw on first down, don't you?
Yeah, you really do. You put a lot of pressure on people by throwing on first down. And, you know, the nice thing about Kramer is the fact that he doesn't eat the ball very often. He gets rid of it somehow,
yes,
some way, and doesn't wind up with second and long yardage, which is so important.
He's very adept at it. He's dumped it off several times today to avert a big loss. Now he has the protection. It's to Ricky Young to the 20. He's out of bounds on the 23-yard line. Ray Claiborne, the left cornerback, hit him there.
See, the great thing about that pass that time, that would have been much better on first down because you get the ball out to the outside, you look downfield, throw it in the flat, let him run with the football. Now it's third and five, but it's a very high percentage pass. He looks downfield and gets the ball to the open receiver, and it's a very good concept.
It'll be third and five. I was a little disappointed in the coach today. I thought for sure he would show up with the Christmas colors, but...
Well, there's a little red here.
Yeah, a little red and blue.
Yeah.
Still all right.
And a little red for the Pope.
Good. All right, Hank. Third and five here. Vikings, their own territory, a New England player they're attending to. And that is Mike Hawkins. Hawkins out. How about an interesting story, Hank, this past week? The Patriot players voted for their former teammate, Leon Gray, who's now with Houston. He was traded to Houston just before the season started, as a top offensive lineman of 1979. The Patriot players.
Yeah, it's always tough when you trade a player from your team and you have gone to the playoffs, and then he goes to another team and they go to the playoffs and you don't. It really magnifies the importance of that particular player. Not that Leon Gray isn't a great performer. He is. But he gets better and better as they continue to win.
And a big controversy here in New England when New England traded him away. An all-pro performer for a number one draft pick. That pass is caught at the 35-yard line. Right on the ball. Coming down with it is Ahmad Rashad. Mike Haynes hit him, and Claiborne.
That was a delayed safety blitz that time. So he got rid of the ball in good shape, got it high. Rashad was able to make that catch. Those are the kind of balls usually when you throw them high. Sometimes you don't get good grasp of the ball. It winds up being a perfect tipping drill. But Rashad has such outstanding hands that he made a beautiful play on that catch.
He's now caught four. And he has 76 catches this season. Kramer gives it off on a sprint. Coming through is Ricky Young. Look at him go. He's over the 50, and Ricky Young stopped for a first down in Patriot territory.
It's the second time they've used that sprint draw. One time to the right for a big gain. They come right back with it to the left side, and he gets another big gain. It looks like the quarterback sells him on the idea that he's going to roll out to his left, and he gives the ball to the tailback, who is back there all by himself, Ricky Young. Saw the seam. The linebacker's got good depth. It looked like it might be a pass. He saw the cavity and took advantage of it, made a nice gain in the play. First and 10.
17-7, the Colts over the Giants. Young going in motion. First down Vikings on the Patriot 45. Hitting off right tackle, Robert Miller. A couple of yards, Mel Lunsford met him there. It'll be second down 8. Ricky Young would be the leading ground gainer in this game now with 59 yards, averaging nearly 6 yards a carry. Give him 3 yards in that. Second and 7, let's call it. Vikings on the Patriot 42. 13-7. Vikings lead. 6:15 to play in the third period. Crowd very quiet.
Minnesota, very intelligent plan, keeping the New England team off balance with a great variety of things they do on first and 10.
Now Kramer looking to field over, going deep to White, incomplete over his head. And he was being chased by Ricky Sanford and Mike Haynes right with him.
You know, he had the impression that he knew he was going to try to get the ball downfield deep, but he saw that there was good coverage on the play and very wisely just threw the ball over the top so it wouldn't be intercepted.
Sammy White has the best average per catch of the Vikings, 17 yards a catch this year. He and Rashad on this team, Stanley Morgan, and Harold Jackson on the Patriots. Each team has an outstanding pair of wide receivers who are home run threats.
Yes, they're terrific, as good as anybody in the league, really.
Third and 7. Terry LeCount's in now. 3 wide receivers on the field for the Vikes. They're in a slot left. And there's a pass. A comeback. It's complete at the 33-yard line. Rick Sanford hits Rashad there, but that's a first down.
The key to the success of that play was the fact that Rashad...
There goes Hawkins out, Hank.
Yep. But Rashad came back for the ball. Had he not done that, he wouldn't have been able to make the catch. But that's why he is such a great receiver. The New England team is stunning on the play, which means they're going laterally trying to get to the passer. And any time you do that, you give the passer that much more time to throw the football.
First down Vikings on the New England 33. Rashad has caught 5 balls in the game. Miller out of motion. Fakes, goes on the run. Wide open is the tight end, Bob Tucker. That's the first time they've gone to him. And we were waiting for it. He's out of bounds on the Patriot 19 and a half.
That same formation with just Young in the backfield. This time he fakes the sprint draw. Play action pass, throws it to Tucker, their fine tight end, number 38 on the outside, lost it over the top in good shape, did a good selling job, hailed the linebackers inside, threw over the top, and another nice gain for the Minnesota Vikings.
4:35 to go in the third period. Minnesota ahead on the scoreboard and in a stat. The score 13-7, Vikings on the 19-yard line of New England. He'll throw again on first down. Back he comes to Ricky Young at the 15, at the 10. Young slips and goes down on the 6. Beautifully executed play. They had them all going one way and came back to Young.
Yeah, he keeps you off balance by the first and 10 passes. And then, of course, the nice thing about that is that it sets up your draws and your screens and slows down the pass rush.
Look how wide open he was, Hank.
Yeah, nobody around him. Got the ball in the wrong arm.
But Rod showed on top of him.
But it was pretty good for distance.
First and goal to go for the Vikings. Again, a drive that is clicking to perfection. They've had a couple of these in this game. Now let's see if Kramer throws on first down or runs it. He's going to throw again on first down. He's got a man wide open. Bad pass to Robert Miller. Had that ball been to him correctly, Miller might have gone right in the end zone.
One of the few times I've seen Kramer hurry himself that time. He was open, knew he had to get the ball to him quickly, but threw it a little bit too fast, prematurely, and for that reason threw it right into the ground.
Second down and six for a Viking touchdown. Tony McGee's coming out on the field. Tony the sack McGee trying to get a pass rush. He replaces Lunsford. They've got to get more heat on Kramer. Kramer's getting a lot of time, and he's hitting his receiver.
The only trouble with it is he gets rid of the ball so quickly so many times that you can't get heat on him.
He's 20 completions in this game. Second down, six. And that is a bump and run pattern. It's no good. Rayburn is covering. Ahmad Rashad draped all over him. Two come back with a nice play. Nice play to each other.
Yes, that was a bump and run defense. He tried to get it over the top. Rashad made a beautiful effort to try to make the catch up above, but couldn't quite come down with the football.
Robert Miller replaces Ted Brown. Brings in a play from Bud Grant. Vikings leading 13-7, 3:28 to go in the third period. The Vikings started this drive on their own 18-yard line. 32 upfield, 44 downfield, 76-yard drive.
Might see the tight end.
Oh, that is clobbered loose. And it was the tight end, Tucker, and Zamberlin, just as the ball was nestling into his chest, wham, yard him loose.
That's who he tried to go to. He was looking right, trying to sell the defense on the fact that he was going to throw to the right side. Tucker popped open, but as he tried to make the catch, he was hit that time by the linebacker.
We're going to have a field goal attempt now. This will be a 24-yard attempt by Rick Danmeyer, who has kicked 12 out of 19. He's 7 out of 11 inside the 40. This kick is up, and he drives it through. So the Vikings 76-yard drive comes to a stall, but the Vikings get on the board with 3 points. 3:19 to play in the third quarter, and Minnesota leads New England 16-7. Minnesota kicking off. Alan Clark deep for New England. Dan Meyer will do the booting. Alan Clark on the 5-yard line. Fakes the reverse. Keeps the ball. Comes out to the 30 and is upset on the 35. Robert Miller jumped him high in the air. Covering the kickoff for the Vikings. This has been a very quiet crowd, Henry, in this third quarter. The New England fans have had nothing to cheer about.
Yes, understandable.
All right, they come up now with a first down, New England. They're 35. They're trailing 16-7.
See if they throw on first and 10. They do.
Rogan looks for the short man. What a catch that was. Don Hasselbeck. Trying to grab it just off his fingertips. He had it, and then Scott Studwell cracked into him and jarred loose.
You know, underneath that time, Ivory was open again, wide open. But he never did see him. He got the ball to the tight end Hasselbeck. But as you saw, he got really dinged on the play and dropped the football.
Second down, 10. And the 49ers lead Atlanta 21-17 in the third quarter. Baltimore 24, the Giants 7. Giants came back and then faded at the end of the year. Pittsburgh 21-0 over Buffalo. They hang on. They'll win their division. We'll tell you about that. Cleveland and Cincinnati tied. Second down, 10. That pass is complete to the 42 of the Patriots. And catching the ball is Calhoun, 44.
He's got to do more of that because Minnesota is dropping very deep. They're playing a zone. The backs are open. If he just takes enough patience to look for the backs in the flat and in the seams, he'll be able to move the ball very well down the field.
Both the Steelers and the Oilers have clinched at least wild spots. If Pittsburgh and Houston win today, then the Steelers win their division. They go down to the net point, and they've more net points in their favor. That is, more points scored than against than Houston would have. We'll be back, 16-7 Vikings. Sam Adams, what a way to wind up the season. Last game, injured leg.
I just hope it's not a serious injury of any kind, and especially not a knee injury. It looks like it might be a cramp or a muscle pull.
Third down and three. Patriots ball on their own 42-yard line. The Vikings lead 16-7. This is Kurt Gowdy with Hank Stram. 2:48 to go in the third quarter.
See if they try to hit one of the backs in the flat or the tight end.
There's that rollout you've been wanting to see. This was not going anywhere. They stop it for a loss. I thought he might roll out and throw on that off the roll. Now there's the score. Cleveland and Cincinnati 6-6. The Browns' only hope for a wild card spot is if Oakland loses to Seattle today and Denver loses to San Diego tomorrow night. But they have to beat the Bengals first. Well, the Browns are not too positive right now for the playoffs. All right, Kevin Miller, the safety man. Eddie Hare kicks it. Low end. Miller on the 30. Running drive to the 35. Picks up a couple of blocks. And then a stop at his 37-yard line. He's hit there by 53. Bill Matthews covering the kick. Tonight on CBS, 60 Minutes, a brand new edition. Then Archie Bunker's place. There's male rivalry on One Day at a Time. And the fourth annual Circus of the Stars, all on CBS tonight. John Smith, the place kicker. Vikings in the lead, 16-7. On their own 37, it's no secret. They're in a rebuilding program, and I'd say the last half of the year has been very positive for them. That's Ricky Young. He's to the 40. Plows his way to his 42-yard line. A 5-yard advance for Ricky Young. Second down, 5 for Minnesota. Uh-oh, Cincinnati's gone ahead, 13-6. Bitter rivalry between those two teams. After Modell fired Paul Brown, they formed the franchise in Cincinnati. They've had some wild games.
Yes, they have, and last year they finished the season with
Look at that one.
Cincinnati winning over Cleveland in the last game of the season. Look at this.
Yeah, Kansas City beats Tampa Bay, and Chicago holds on to their lead against St. Louis. The Bears will win the division. Kramer to the sideline. Ahmad Rashad. Look at this, two different shoes. Got that one, and for that surface. Explain it, kicker. Explain that, Hank.
Well, evidently he feels that there's a better leverage on his left foot with the shoe that he's wearing, so it doesn't slip or slide on the wet turf. So evidently he changed the left shoe so that he could get better traction on the wet synthetic turf.
I hope that doesn't get him fired like Thomas Henderson. He's got quite a story, John Smith. I think he tried out over here in the airport. He tried out in Kennedy Airport. Got off a plane and said, here's the ball, kick it. He kicked it and they hired him. Rashad on that last catch, especially for fans of the Vikings, they had many around the country. Rashad is now the all-time Viking receiver in yardage. He now has 3,301 yards in receiving, breaking John Gilliam's club mark of 3,297. Well, Sid Hartman will root for that. He liked John Gilliam. He was a big fan of Gilliam's, and same with Rashad. Sid's getting too old, Hank, to come on the road anymore.
I got a nice note from Sid the other day, and I appreciated it very much.
He never wrote me. Third down inches.
Should go left if they do go left. Or straight ahead with the fullback lined up the way he is. No, they wind up going the other way.
And they have a first down. Ricky Young makes it. Vikings just staying on the ground. Last drive they had, they were throwing on first down. Now they're playing very conservatively. Well, they're in the lead, 16-7.
Well, that was a good key breaker that time because they were really tilted to the left like they were going to run left and ran to the right. And evidently it fooled the defense a little bit because he was able to make the necessary yardage for the first down.
Let us explain to many who Sid Hartman is. He's a sports writer, a longtime sports writer in Minneapolis for the Minneapolis Star Tribune. Also a radio performer.
Mr. Versatile.
Kramer to the sideline. As his receiver again, Ahmad Rashad. In front of Raymond Claiborne. And Rashad has 7 catches.
Well, he is really poetry in motion, too, isn't he?
He knows how to do it. He knows how to work those sideline markers. And then if you get crowd him, bang, he'll take off on you.
The great thing about him, he's always under control. He's always traveling at the same pace, it looks like. And as a result, he makes his breaks accordingly and is very difficult to cover.
First and 10, Minnesota on the Patriot 40-yard line. Coming through is Ted Brown, first down to the 28-yard line of New England. The rookie dropped in the secondary by Rick Samford. And the Vikings have outplayed the Patriots. They have an injury down right now. So we're going to the fourth period here in Foxborough, Massachusetts, with a score 16-7. Now a word from your local station. The Super Bowl ring of Hank Stram, Super Bowl IV, when his club beat the Vikings. And that's what the Super Bowl is all about, that ring. And CBS will be there on January 20th to cover the Super Bowl, 106,000 in Pasadena, California.
You got that hand looked like Frankenstein's hand, didn't it?
Not quite. Vikings on the move. They're on the Patriot 28-yard line. They have a first down. Here's Ricky Young. Young's to the 25-yard line of the Patriots, a 3-yard gain. Vikings have controlled the play in the second half. They outperformed the Patriots in the first half. They have run more plays from scrimmage. They've had the ball more times. They've had 3 long marches. Look at the first downs, 21-8.
The one thing about Minnesota, they've been very, very unpredictable in this game. It's hard to read what they're going to do, and Kramer's really done an excellent job of moving the formations around and again throwing the ball and using a good package on first and 10.
Second down, 7. Now he's going to throw this down. He gets rid of it to the sideline over the head of Sammy White. Purposely threw it out of bounds. 3rd and 7 for the Vikings on the New England 25. Kurt Gowdy, Hank Stram, we have just opened the fourth quarter. Bad weather late in the first quarter, all during the second quarter. Hard rain at halftime, and then it suddenly stopped raining early in the third period. And it hasn't rained since. And the big dark clouds are still hovering over, but no snow yet. There are the figures for Kramer, 22 out of 39, nearly 200 yards. He definitely is a real comer in the National Football League. He's a difference, I think, some of the difference between the two conferences. The other 2 or 3, 4 years, he'll be where a lot of the quarterbacks in age and experience are in the American Conference. Stabler, Greasy, Bradshaw.
It's not going to take him long to get to where he's going to go because he's got terrific credentials.
Look at that. Oh, he didn't quite hold on to it. Great attempt there by Ricky Young. He nearly had an amazing one-handed snag.
And as I mentioned earlier, you know, the great thing about him is that he's very hard to sack. He'll somehow, some way, get rid of the football so he doesn't wind up with 2nd and 18, 2nd and 20, and that's so important.
And without throwing it into the arms of somebody. This will be a 43-yard attempt. Paul Cross will hold, who now holds the all-time record for intercepting passes in the National Football League. Low snap, the kick is up, and the kick hits the bar. Hit the crossbar, no good. And my adjustment. All right, back in Foxborough in just a moment. The Vikings still lead 16-7. Patriots ball on their 25-yard line with a first down. They have made only 1 first down in the second half. They have been throttled by the Vikings. They've had a field goal, the only score in the second half. This is a first down pass off the fingertips of Harold Jackson. Incomplete, 2nd down 10 for New England.
It looked like Jackson and also the tight end Hasselbeck were very close together. It's a wonder that he was open like he was.
Let's get on Jim Marshall, number 70, playing his last game, topping off a 20-year career. The only survivors from his first year, 1961, are Stubby Eason, the team equipment manager, trainer Fred Zamberletti, and the club doctor, Don Lannan. Jim Marshall, an amazing athlete, 42 years old, and retiring today after 20 years in the game. Second down, 10. Deep pass, post pattern, incomplete. Flag down. You may have had interference by John Turner there. Or Paul Krause may have bumped him coming into the post pattern. Earl Jackson was running it.
And here again, the ball was thrown way over the top. It was a needless penalty because he had no chance whatsoever to make the reception on the play. Grogan back to throw directly from the pocket. Plenty of time. Throws in the middle area. Over the top. A little bit too long.
Turner's the man that interfered with him. That's their second first down of the half. Patriots have the ball on the Viking 43. Third penalty against Minnesota. Reverse. A pass, Westbrook throwing to Hasselbeck at the 30. Tied into the 25. And down to the 19. A reverse to the wide receiver. And he throws the left-hander pass to the tight end. And the Patriots trying to open things up.
And he even made a spiral.
Yes.
Good-looking play. Another recess football play. Makes a good move to the outside. Westbrook does. Throws it on the move to Hasselbeck. Makes the catch. Hasselbeck did a good job that time of not overrunning the ball. He stopped. And the ball, he looked like it was going to be thrown underneath. He stopped and made the catch first and then took off and started to run again. Good presence by Don Hasselbeck.
On two plays, the Patriots move 66 yards. There's Grogan, 15, still going, and out of bounds. It'll be first and goal to go. Grogan running one of his favorite sprint out patterns. Tim Baylor drove him out on the 3-yard line.
That's what puts so much pressure on the defense when he does that kind of thing. He did it so many times early in his career, and so far this season, I've always been very surprised that he hasn't run more and thrown more rollout passes, because defenses hate to see him do that.
First and goal to go. They started this drive on their 75. Three plays later, they're on a Viking 3 as the Patriots suddenly explode. That's John Smith, the place kicker, warming up his leg. Ivory and Calhoun lined up behind Grogan. Calhoun. 1 yard line where he stopped by Jeff Seaman. He got underneath that play. It'll be second down. A yard to go for a Patriot touchdown that could put them right back in with 12:38 to play. Here's where you miss the Sam Cunningham.
Yes, of course, he jumps over the top so well.
Yeah, I did the Rose Bowl game when he dived over four times from the 1 yard line. Was named the most valuable player and said he didn't deserve it. Second down, yard to go. Calhoun scores. And the Patriots went 75 yards. Six plays. And they're right back in the picture. Funny ball club.
Here we see a good surge on the left side. John Hanna, the left guard, does a good job of coming off the ball, as does Lane Titus, Kreider, Rock, all of whom do a good job and provide Calhoun with the opportunity to get in for the touchdown.
An important extra point. Minnesota missed their first extra point after scoring in the game. And this one by Smith's good, and now a field goal to put them out in front. 75 yards, five plays, took them 147. The score, 16-14, Minnesota. Here's a short kick by John Smith. Ted Brown took it on the 18 to the 25 to the 30 and rolls up to the Viking 33-yard line, where they'll put the ball in play and now trying to protect a two-point lead. instead of a 9-point lead. John Smith with that extra point now has scored 108 points. He and Earl Campbell are tied for the lead in scoring in the National Football League. There's the story of the Patriot drive. Vikings ball, their own 33-yard line. First down, 12:05 to play in the game. Something wrong with the yard. Six are getting them up. Fourth quarter, Pittsburgh 21, Buffalo nothing. Looks like Pittsburgh will be claimed the winner of the Central Division. A shot out of bounds. Even though Houston wins today, you go down the next, the first tiebreaker of how they did against each other, then in how they did in the division, then the conference, and they have to go all the way down to their total points scored against the points scored against them, and Pittsburgh will win on it. Matt Cavanaugh, the backup quarterback. Pittsburgh will be a host team.
In the meantime, Rashad Ritty was double cover that time, had a hard time getting off the line of scrimmage. Claiborne was all over him, but he still broke loose and was able to make that catch for 4 yards.
Rashad has 8 catches in the game for 68 yards. Ricky Young to the 40-yard line of the Vikings. And the Vikings have a 3rd and 3. Take a look at some more scores as they come in here. This is the fourth period of 49ers over the Falcons. Fourth quarter, Baltimore over the Giants, who faded the last 3 weeks of the season. Pittsburgh, as we told you, leading Buffalo 21-0. 13-6, Cincinnati over Cleveland. That would knock Cleveland out of any possible playoff hope, and all they have is a possible hope. 3-0. Tampa Bay, if they hold on to that lead, can win their division. They've been trying to clinch it for 4 weeks. 3rd down and 3. Kramer to the sideline, out of bounds at the 42-yard line.
Boy, what a catch by Young.
Ricky Young. I think he's short, though, Henry.
Short covered him well, but in spite of that, he still made the catch, but I don't think he made the necessary yardage. You're right. He didn't make it for the first down.
4th down, punt formation. With 11:08 to play, 16-14, Vikings. Red Coleman. Uh-oh, they're shifting out of it now in a hurry. They're going for the first down. And they don't make it. Brent McClanahan. Brent McClanahan is stopped by Mosi Kotupu. Kotupu stopped him. They gambled. They went out of a punt into a shift. And here it is.
Yeah, we see it. And Kotupu, as you mentioned, he comes across there. And Ritty makes the hit.
They backfire. We'll see when we come back. Jim Marshall, number 70, playing his last game ever in the National Football League. 20-year career. Last week, he became the first Viking in history to ever be presented a game ball by the coach, Bud Graham.
See if they throw the ball here on 1st and 10, especially the Jackson on the other side. They've been successful with a play-action pass.
1st down, Patriots on the Vikings 41. They are going to throw. They go down the middle. He's open. Touchdown. You called it. Earl Jackson. Minnesota's fake punt backfired. And the Patriots have the lead.
Boy, he put it right on the money that time. Play action pass. Right up on top into the post. What a beautiful catch. Again, they continue to lick John Turner, the left corner, number 27. And right by him.
40 yards for the touchdown. That's the 496th career catch for Jackson. That moves him past Tommy McDonald now. 9th place all time. The all-time leader is Charlie Taylor, who was with the Redskins for 13 years. Here's a kick by Smith that is good. The Patriots look to be out of this game, 16-7. They struck suddenly on a quick drive and then take over after a fake punt and score again. Patriots 21, Vikings 16. there. Steve Grogan, who had just thrown his 28th touchdown pass, he may be ahead of Brian Sight now, the leader of the National Football League. Here's the kickoff. Edwards deep is going to ground it wisely for the touchback, Jimmy Edwards. Vikings ball. Well, that punt, they lined up in punt formation and then shifted on fourth down and one, and they took too long after the shift. They let the Patriots get set.
That's the thing that you have to do. If you're going to shift, any time that you shift, you must shift and do it, whatever you're going to do, very quickly. That time they shifted, they delayed. By that time, the New England team responded to what they saw, made a great play, and wound up with good field position and go ahead in this game right now, 21-16.
All right, Vikings had the ball on their 20. Up until these last two Patriots scores, which exploded suddenly, Vikings had badly outplayed New England. There's the pass to White. It's intercepted by Raymond Claiborne. Is at the 35, the 30, the 25, the 20, and down in the 20, the 18-yard line. How the complexion has suddenly changed.
Play-action pass, and they try to hit Rashad on the inside. He got plenty of time to throw the ball. Claiborne really makes a great play. I'm sorry, it's not Rashad, it's Sammy White. But Claiborne does a great job of running the football, making the interception. He takes the ball down to the 18-yard line, and they have good field position again. Another great opportunity to get more points on the scoreboard.
First turnover by the Vikings. All right, the Patriots ball and the Viking 18. This game has dramatically changed in complexion. Calhoun to the 15-yard line of Minnesota. Gain of 3, second down 7. Patriots had the ball behind 16.
A touchdown pass to Harold Jackson with Jackson's 70th touchdown pass.
First down in the second half. And then they went 75 yards in six plays. Vikings got the ball back. Failed to make a first down on a fake punt. We're on a running play. Patriots scored in the next play. Here the Patriots right back in the game. Set it down 7.
He might work on Turner. Oop.
That's number 77, Mark Mullaney, on top of Grogan. Grogan's down to the 25-yard line. Grogan is been an interesting story in New England. They're up, the fans are raving about him 1 week. Look at the half, Bears over the Cards. Maybe for not, though, Tampa Bay holds on to their 3-0 lead. And the next week, you're down on him, but here he is with 28 touchdown passes, which probably is good enough to lead the NFL.
Well, I don't know. If he is a good quarterback, I don't know who is. Look at all the room on that right side.
Flags are down. Grogan throws incomplete. He hit, big rush on him by Duck White, number 72. And we have flags dropped. John Hanna is injured. The all-pro guard, number 73 from Alabama. Time remaining in this game, 9 minutes, 21 seconds. 21-16. Patriots ahead. Penalty maybe against the Vikings.
Yeah, we see the penalty finally. Let's hear what they say.
That is Matt Blair. 59. On the 15-yard line, third down, 7.
See if they work on Turner on the left side. No, they're gonna run the ball.
There's a flag down. Horace Ivory shot into the end zone, but a flag is down. Ivory scored, but it may be back. Let's see what they're gonna call this one. It looked like he was a shot out of a cannon when he went through.
Boy, he really blew through there, didn't he?
That's Hasselbeck was injured and tied in. A as he's hit in the face. This is holding, and the touchdown is nullified. And another player down for the Vikings is Tom Hannon, the safety. They're dropping all over the field here in the last game of the regular season. 9 minutes, 17 seconds left to play in this game. That touchdown would have done heavy damage.
14, number 80.
Son Hasselbeck, the tight end, who's also on the artificial surface. The touchdown does not go. The ball will be placed back on the Viking 25. It'll be third down and 17.
Boy, he blew through there like it was a bag drill that time. Here we see him coming off the ball. It was just a straight handoff with man-for-man blocking. He darted through the hole and got into the end zone. Beautiful run. Great blocking at the point of attack.
4 years ago, a giant American chemical company was told by one of its own engineers that it was slowly contaminating water wells adjoining the plant. Did the company do anything about it? Watch 60 Minutes tonight, right after NFL football, here on CBS. You know, a great football fan, Mike Wallace.
Is he?
Yeah, I met great CBS news commentator up at the Major League Baseball meetings who I didn't know what an outstanding sports fan he was, especially baseball, Charles Carroll.
Yeah, it's amazing. You know, really, so many of the entertainers are terrific football fans.
Well, Tampa Bay did it. Boy, they just nudged the tip of their nose across the finish line. They beat Kansas City today 3-0. Their defense did it, and they win the Central Division crown. Had they lost today, they would have lost their last four games and blown it all because the Bears are winning. But Tampa Bay will be in the playoffs, an expansion team in their fourth year.
Well, we got to congratulate Mr. Culverhouse, Mr. C, and Johnny McKay, and Dick Beam, and all those great people, the fine coaches, Abe Griffin, and all those people down in Tampa.
All right, third down, 17. New England leading in this game, 21-16. Rogan's toss, no good. He was trying to get it to Harold Jackson, but it struck the surface about 5 yards. I don't think he knew where the player was.
They've thrown that pass on four occasions, and each time Ivory is wide open. He's very disgusted coming to the bench because there was nobody around him whatsoever. I don't know why he hasn't seen him in that middle area, because had he thrown the ball to him, he could have scampered for a long gain and got them very much closer for the field goal.
John Smith will try a 42-yard field goal. As we told you earlier, he's been very accurate inside the 40, making 16 out of 18 inside the 40. This kick is up, and this one's riding. It is good. Smith kicks the field goal, and the Patriots now have a 24-16 lead. We'll be back with the Patriot kickoff in Foxborough, Massachusetts, right after this. 15. Talking about retired players, Jim Marshall playing his last game today for the Vikings. O.J. Simpson out with the 49ers, retiring today. Tom Neville, 13 years with the Patriots, 2 years with the Giants, offensive tackle, is also playing his last National Football League game today.
Yes, he's played a lot of great football for these two respective teams, and a class guy along with it.
New England has rallied in the fourth quarter. They were trailing 16-7. They suddenly exploded, and they lead now 24-16. 9 minutes and 7 seconds to play. The Vikings had everything going their way. And suddenly, the Patriots ripped the bag open and escaped. Here's Edwards up to the 10, 20, 25, out of bounds. On the 26-yard line. Alan Clark knocking out of bounds. Now the Vikings had this game just completely in command. And suddenly, what happened?
It's amazing how the personality of a game can change, and it changed dramatically on the fourth down attempt when they went for it and didn't make it. They had great field position on about the 40-yard line, threw a touchdown pass to Jackson, and turned the game around totally.
First down, Vikings on their 26.
6-3, ready two.
Ted Brown out in motion. Ricky Young, he's stopped along the line of scrimmage by Richard Bishop. Bishop, the knifing right in, 64. It'll be second down on the Viking 27, second and nine. Time remaining, 8.5 minutes. Vikings have been getting beat to death in the fourth period. They've been outscored 121-58 in the fourth quarter of their games this year. More than double. The opponents have doubled the score on them in the fourth. There's the pass. It is complete to Ricky Young. A sliding grab for a first down to the Viking 44.
You know, one thing watching this team play, they don't lose their poise. They hang in there tough, and they continue to do what they feel they can do. There's a great illustration of it. He had to move around a little bit in the pocket, but got the ball to Ricky Young, and they maintained possession, first and 10.
Don Hasselbeck is all right. I think he had a clout in the face. Mouse all right. Vikings will come up with a first down. Giants getting pasted. Pittsburgh on their way with a tiebreaker to win their division over Buffalo and be a host team in the playoffs, the defending Super Bowl champ. Short pass is good to Ted Brown. Brown is pushed out on the Viking 49-yard line by Rod Schoate and Mike Haynes. Five-yard pickup, second and five.
It was just a play-action pass, not much of a fake at all. The mesh between the quarterback and the back was very poor. But he got the ball on target in good shape to Ted Brown, and he's knocked out of bounds by number 40, Mike Haynes.
24-16, New England ahead. I don't know what they're doing here. Something, officials had to get something straight now. Now they start the clock again. Oh, they really haven't. Second down, five.
Look at a cut in this guy's head. Look at a gash in this guy's head.
That's Ricky Young. He's to the Patriot 45-yard line. Ricky Young coming out of that backfield. That's his 11th catch. He's gonna have to take some aspirin tonight. Pete Brock there, the left tackle of the Patriots. Another first down for the Vikings. Now they're moving.
And Brock is a very versatile player. Plays offensive center, offensive tackle, tight end on occasions, wing back, snaps the ball on centers, snaps. He's a very valuable guy to have in your football team.
Tommy Kramer has passed the ball 45 times today. Completed 27. Here's his 46 coming up. And he hits his receiver at the 40 of the Patriots. Robert Miller, the back coming out. He's just picking away at it.
Sprays the ball around, doesn't he? He gets the ball to a lot of receivers. Everybody but the tight end. The tight end has only caught one ball today. That's unusual.
Atlanta gone by the 49ers, 31-21, fourth period. They have 6.5 minutes to play here. New England ahead by eight. Terry LeCount becomes the third wide receiver, number 80. Second down, five. Again, the clock stops.
This game's a long way from being over, Kurt. 6:30 left in the game. The way this Minnesota team moves the football, a lot can still happen in the remaining 6 minutes.
Well, it happened very quickly for New England. Timeout on the field.
Please drive safely.
Time out. There's something wrong Is it the clock? I don't know. There's something wrong down the end of the field. Now the signal comes up. The Patriots call timeout. I don't know why they call timeout. Unless something was messed up out there or they had something wrong. Because they've stopped the clock and they have two timeouts left. And every time they stop the clock, they give the Vikings the advantage to try and get back in this game with a score 24-16 New England. When play is resumed, it'll be second down and five to go for Minnesota. Trying to score quickly here.
He had second and five. Ready three, take three. Front one. Ready two. Two.
Kramer eluding rushers. First down. Sammy White to the New England 24-yard line. Prentice McCray spun him down, and Kramer has the Vikings moving. First down on the Patriot 24.
He's a piece of work, Kramer is, that time. He had pressure coming inside, jumped to the outside, and got rid of the ball nicely to Sammy White. Another first down.
They're going to spot him on the 25. Well, the Bears are rolling away from the Cardinals, but it doesn't matter. The Bears closed the season in impressive style, but Tampa Bay won today 3-0 over Kansas City and won the division. Bears nearly pulled it out. First down, Vikings on the Patriot 25. Slant. And the receiver was running the wrong way, Terry LeCount. Kramer was throwing, yeah, that's right. He should be unhappy. He thought it should have been a slant pattern. The receiver just going down when he backed to the ball.
That's a read pattern, I think, Kurt. What happened, the young receiver didn't read it properly. The quarterback did. He anticipated his going into the area where he threw the football, and LeCount didn't even know the ball was thrown. So there had to be a mix-up in the automatic read of the young receiver. LeCount, Terry LeCount, number 80.
Second down, 10. Vikings on the Patriot 25. Patriots leading 24-16. He shoots it. It is a diving catch. It is complete to the 13-yard line to Terry LeCount, one of the better catches of the game, in front of Rick Samford, the safety man.
Well, he really made up for it that time. That was a fantastic catch, a diving catch. The ball was thrown a little bit low, but out in front, but he got it out there close to where he was, and he made a fine catch out in front, low enough, kept possession of it. Another big play for the Minnesota Vikings.
Patriots leading by 8, trying to wind up the season by snapping a 3-game loss string. By the way, we had an unusual situation here. Tommy Kramer was the only quarterback coming into this game to play every offensive play so far this year. But that streak was snapped today. There it is, wide open. Ricky Young at the 10, the 5. Young is over for a touchdown. The Vikings are back. Young diving in. Mike Haynes.
Boy, that was a nice-looking play. He faked to the back and threw across the grain. Everybody was chasing on the play.
That's an official down, Hank. I think Mike Haynes inadvertently clipped him. See if we can pick it up on this rerun.
See, he fakes the Young, rolls to his right, and then throws back to Young. Everybody was pursuing the other way. He was wide open. Let's see what happens here.
There's the official. Down. Yeah. That's Mike Haynes diving across. Didn't clip him. He got him in front. The rolling block. Coaches would like to see blocks like that out in the field, but not on the officials. We're talking, here it is again. Watch this here. Let's see the hit now. Here's Young escaping Haynes.
But he slides into the official here, you see. He just slides into him and then rolls and knocks him down. Let's just hope it's nothing serious.
I don't believe it is. It's all right.
Good.
Talking about Tommy Kramer. On that 4th-and-1 play, the Minnesota lined up in a punt formation and then switched into a shift. They had Steve Dills, a third-string quarterback, who took a direct pass from center and handed off to McClanahan. And so Tommy Kramer does not wind up the season being in on every offensive play for the Vikings. He's going to miss one unless they take him out. All right, we'll have the try for point by Rick Danmeyer. The kick is up. Kick is good. We've got quite a game here. 5:25 to play, and it's the Patriots 24, the Vikings 23. Kurt Gowdy and Hank Stram, and our game today has been produced by Chuck Will, directed by Duke Strutt. That's his right name. Michael Albanese, the associate producer. Doug Fleetham, the field operations engineer. Frank Basso, Stu Meyer, technical director. George Spillett, Fred Lopez, audio. David Fruitman, Lou Leger, Sandy Corrado. There's all the cameras. Tony Connor, Richard Douglas, Barry Drago, Sig Meyers, Jim Murphy. Thank you, gentlemen, very much. Whoa, we still have more. Mike Singer, Al Cohen, Trustum, I like that. Trustum, DeVoe, and Jimmy Richardson. Clyde Bonney, John Butler. Here's the kickoff. Circling around. They boot it on a fumble. Patriots have the ball on their 42, 43-yard line. Mostly the Tupo recovers. Patriots have good field position. Now they are trying to protect a one-point lead. Vikings were out in front handily, blew their lead. The Patriots, they went out in front by eight. They softened up. And this, Hank Stram said about 2 or 3 minutes ago, this one is not over yet.
And New England really should come right out throwing the ball, being very aggressive, not trying to sit in that one-point lead, because if they do, they're going to be in trouble.
Starting to rain again. Rained all the first half. This is Horace Ivory. Ivory to the 46-yard line of the Patriots. Gain of 3, 2nd and 7. Final score coming up. Baltimore clobbers the Giants, 31-7. Sad ending for the Giants, who lost their first 5, came back, gave their fans hopes, and then sagged again at the end.
Yeah, we saw them last week against the Cardinals, and they were not very impressive, and evidently they didn't play very well again today.
I'll leave you to figure it out.
we can figure it out anymore. We'd bottle it and sell it.
Second down, 7. Jackson in motion. Rogan to Morgans. Morgans being contained, and he stopped right there by Randy Holloway, number 75.
Took too long to make a decision that time. He should have just taken the ball as soon as he saw the crack and got as much as he could. The minute you start dancing, everybody comes from the inside, and then it's all over.
They lost 2. They have a 3rd down and 9.
Here's a quick screen. It's a very poor mesh and a very poor fake between Ivory and the quarterback. But see, there was a little running room inside, but by the time he waited to make a decision, it was much too late.
And Brock,
Brock made a good block on the outside man.
3rd and 9. Let's see if they blitz. They're going in on him. He unloads. He's got him open. 20. He read the blitz. Errol Jackson caught it. They read the blitz. He just unloaded it to him. And now it's a different game again.
It was man-for-man coverage, and John Turner, number 27, was looking into the backfield. Jackson ran right by him. It's one thing that you cannot do on man-for-man. You've got to stay with the man all the way. He ran right by him as he was looking into the backfield. For that reason, the New England Patriots have fine field position on about the 13-yard line.
And there are 3 minutes and 18 seconds to play. Jackson has 5 catches today for 147 yards.
They've really done a number on John Turner, the left cornerback, and it's not so much that he's not a good player, except they have so much respect for Bryant that they threw him the other side.
That's an average of 29 yards a catch, Errol Jackson, today. There goes Ivory. Ivory's to the 12-yard line, and that's all. And he was tackled by Scott Studwell. It'll be 2nd down, 9. New England on the Vikings 12-yard line. We're down to 2:35 to go in this game with a score New England 24, Minnesota 23. Sounds like an NBA game midway in the first period. Jackson had just came with that catch and a couple of more. Had 1,003 yards for the season, another 1,000-yarder this year. Brogan throwing in the end zone over the head of Jackson. Jackson also has had the 27th 100-yard game of his career today.
Well, he's an easy rider. He's got a good pace, and here again, he's got very deceptive speed. He's got a long stride and covers a lot of real estate as he travels downfield making catches. Talking about Harold Jackson, number 29.
Third down, 9. That pass over the head of Stanley Morgan. By the way, when you saw Morgan, you saw Jackson. Both Morgan and Jackson have gone over the 1,000-yard mark on one team.
Morgan a little upset here. Thought he had a chance to make the catch, but it was thrown way above and incomplete.
2 minutes to go. A one-point lead for New England, 24-23. There's the score, 24-23. Looking ahead to next year, the Vikings will play all four clubs in the AFC Central. They've got it tough. Pittsburgh, Houston, Cleveland, and Cincinnati, plus two from the NFC East. Two more from the NFC West, besides two games each with teams in their own division. Patriots will play all four teams from the NFC West next year, two more from the AFC Central, and two more from the AFC West.
One thing that New England has to worry about here on fourth down, they have to concern themselves about the ability that Minnesota has to block kicks. They have to do a good job of protecting on this kicker. They could block it.
Vikings have blocked 13 assorted kicks this year. Smith, who's deadly inside the 40, will be trying a 30-yard field goal. It's up, and the kick is good. Now that means the Vikings have to come back and get a touchdown or a couple of field goals in a hurry. They'll be back. New England 27, Minnesota 23. We're talking about next year's schedule. It makes a lot of difference whether you finish fourth or fifth sometimes in a division. For instance, Kansas City, they lost today. And Oakland is playing Seattle later. Kansas City finished fourth in their division, which they probably won't. They would have hosted Dallas, Pittsburgh, Miami, and Washington in Kansas City. By finishing fifth, they'll play Cincinnati, Baltimore, and Detroit. That's a lot of difference in the gate between those opponents.
And there's still a lot of time left in this game with 1:56 left in the game with three timeouts for Minnesota.
That's Edwards back up. He runs into a couple of Patriots at the 20-yard line of the Vikings. They're 80 yards away. Don Hasselbeck led the charge downfield with a minute 50 to go. 27-23 New England. Tommy Kramer today, there's a final. Pittsburgh is the division winner. They win today 28-0, no matter what Houston does against the Eagles, on the tie-breaking net points in favor. Pittsburgh gets the division title and will be the host in the playoffs in their divisional game. All right, Kramer's thrown 51 passes, most he's ever thrown in a game, and that's incomplete. Ray Claiborne breaking it up with Ted Brown. Previously, the most passes attempted by Kramer was 49. 52 now. He's completed 31 today. That's his all-time high.
It's unusual when you throw that many passes in a game that you still have a chance to win, but they're in that position, and they still have a chance with 1:44 left in the game.
And, Henry, that is also a Viking record, breaking Van Tarkenton's record of 30 completions. Today, young Kramer holds an all-time Viking record with 31 completions. But New England's leading by 4 points. Second down, 10. They got him under the rush. Here's Ricky Young out of the backfield. Young is dropped at the 21-yard line. A one-yard gain and an excellent play by Raymond Claiborne. 1:30 to go. Moving down. Vikings have their full complement of timeouts. Patriots have two left. 27-23 New England.
Had that been a longer pass downfield, they probably would have called timeout, but they didn't have to call the timeout.
A short one, they have a first down. Important first down for him. Time call, Ricky Young caught it. And the Vikings come in and stop the clock with a minute eight to go.
That's usually the rule of thumb. You get the ball downfield, then of course you're going to use one of the timeouts.
There's the score, 4 points, New England leading. ...27-23 New England. They had an 8-point lead and Minnesota came back with a drive and a touchdown. There are the timeouts, two for each team, a minute eight to go. The ball will be on the 31-yard line of the Vikings. First and 10. There's Hasselbeck going into the locker room, the tight end. Today is the first time the Patriot defense. Let's see if anybody's got a 100-yard game. Nope. They've not allowed a runner or a pass receiver to make 100 yards in the game this year, their defense. Kramer, look out from behind. He throws, and getting into the sideline and out of bounds is Sammy White at the 44 of the Vikings. He just took Raymond Claiborne right with him and crossed the boundary line. That's quite a record. Patriot defense has not allowed either a receiver or a running back a 100-yard game. But wait a minute. Young has 100 yards today. On receiving, 109 yards. First time this year. One man has done it, and that's Ricky Young against the Patriot defense. There's your time. Another first down for the Vikings. Two timeouts left. They're going short. 50-yard line. Ricky Young, who's been outstanding, catching the ball, running the ball, a real all-purpose back today. To the New England 49-yard line.
Injured player.
49 seconds to play. Steve Grogan.
That is the second timeout. Minnesota.
And we'll be back here. Grogan laughs it up with the score, 27-23 New England. And they correct that score, 27-23, New England, 49 seconds to play, one timeout left for the Vikings. One more word about Jim Marshall. He said he's leaving sports, leaving football, but not retiring from life. That I'm a talented man, and I'm still young, and I have a lot of other things to do and challenges ahead of me after completing 20 years of a great career. And that is sort of, to me, a sad thing about sports. They call them old when they're 31, 32, or they quit when they're 35. The old man retired, he quit. Really, their whole lives are still almost ahead of them.
Well, it's great when they have it all in the right perspective and know what their priorities are, and I'm sure Jim Marshall is fully aware of what he wants to do and what a full life he has ahead.
All right. Second down, 2 yards to go. Young heading for those sidelines, trying to get out of bounds. And he can't do it, but he has a first down. They're at the New England 41-yard line. The clock moving. They'll have to hurry up. 27-23 New England. 30 seconds to play. Quick snap here. Tommy Kramer broken the all-time completion record for the Vikings. That's incomplete. And again going to Ricky Young. Ricky Young's going to have an aching body on that flight home. He's been all over this field.
With the way they're playing defensively, he's taken exactly what they're giving him, and he'll break a tackle and make a big play and get him down there close enough where maybe they'd get one-on-one coverage and then try to get the ball in for a big play.
Patriots have been involved with some close ones this year. They dropped two overtime games by 3 points, suffered 1 point loss and a 5 point loss. Second and 10 for the Vikings, trailing by four, last 30 seconds. The pass, oh, should have been intercepted. Right into the hands of Steve Nelson. That's why Steve's a middle linebacker, not a wide receiver.
Third down.
Here he goes. They have so much bandage and wrapping around their arms and hands, I don't know how they can catch a football.
Unless the Vikings score in the last 19 seconds, New England will wind up with 9 wins and 7 losses. The Vikings with 7-9.
Here's a Big Ben play where all three receivers are on the outside.
Big Ben, that means going against the clock. Wild gamble. Kramer out of the pocket, to the 40, to the 35, to the 30, to the 25, down to the 23, and they rush in and stop the clock. 9 seconds to go. The Vikings not giving up. The way to play it. See the team going into the playoffs and playing it right down to the last 9 seconds, and we'll be back. Big day for Harold Jackson on the left, 147 yards. Stanley Morgan, only 2 catches, but both of them wind up the season with at least 1,000 yards in receiving, and they have caught more touchdowns together than any other pair of receivers in NFL at 1-2. Jackson, the veteran, tragic injury to Darrell Stingley, eliminated Stingley from the playing field. The Patriots went right out and made a deal with the Rams and got Jackson in here. They moved quickly, shut Fairbanks, and didn't waste time. 9 seconds to go. The ball on the New England 22-yard line. Minnesota maybe has 2 chances.
They got to try to throw the ball in the end zone or have some kind of a big play. See what they do.
He has a protection. There's a throw. Incomplete. Knocked down by Ray Kostick, who should have intercepted it also. One more shot for the Minnesota Vikings. Well, this is something. The 16th game, they're long seasons now, they're grueling. You come out here, and this is it. Both teams are out of it. The Vikings for the first time since 72. New England's been disappointing in the last part of the year, yet they both played hard, and the game goes down and hinges on the last play in the last 4 seconds. Right in. Here it is. Now throws in the end zone. It is incomplete. All over. That's the end of the game.